I cannot eat a lot or much of red meat or shellfish because I have gout. Gout is a disease that makes my acid levels much higher than most people's. And so if I eat certain foods, my acid level elevates, skyrockets, and then I get all giant swelling and incredible pain in my joints.
Hey.
Yeah.
Hey, gout walk. Ooh. Little gin, little door, that shrimp make the gout hot. Hey. I can feel it in my toes, let's go, it's the gout walk. Damn. Stomach cold, so froze, you know I got the gout rocks. Ah. Take a 20-minute break, I'ma hit him with a gout walk. Sushi day, I'ma tear it up. Oh shit, here comes another flare up. Door dash me a little aloe vera. A bowl of penne and a side of marinara. I could introduce you to the gout.
To the gout.
Daddy foods every time when I go out. Bitch, I'm too fast, why I pass out?
Pass
where
out.
The Chevy juice at? Need a glass now.
Glass now. Yeah.
Gotta go and see the doc. Man, it's like a couple blocks. Hold up, another $100 shot. Now I'ma hit him with a walk.
Hey, what walk?
Gout walk.
Ooh.
Little gin, little door, that shrimp make the gout hot.
Hey.
I can feel it in my toes, let's go, it's the gout walk.
Damn.
Stomach cold, so froze, you know I got the gout rocks.
Ah.
Take a 20-minute break, I'ma hit him with a gout walk.
Basically had a big gout flare-up because I stopped drinking cherry juice. And since I started drinking it again, I haven't had one since. I will likely be drinking tart cherry juice for the rest of my life. And quite frankly, those people who make that shit up should be sued. They should be sued into oblivion. But I'm not a rich man, and I don't have the means to do it. You know, some of that stuff out there has been insanely damaging and messed up, the things they said about me and my family. That's completely false, and they have absolutely no factual corroboration for any of it.
Who?
I'm a dunce. I'm a dunce. Yes, that's true. He's a pedophile. He's a racist. He's a sexist. Yes, that's true. I smell. I'm a dunce. Offensive. Egregious cross-dresser. Yes, that's true. Gifted a body that has a lot of shortcomings, okay? Bad back injury. A severely herniated gout. You oozing with grit. Postnasal gout. Gout is a disease that makes me act like an ass. He's a racist. He's a sexist. He's a scammer. He's this. He's that. Yes, that's true. I'm a dunce. I'm a dunce. Yes, that's true. He's a pedophile. He's a racist. He's a sexist. Yes, that's true. I smell. I'm a dunce. Stupid mouth drooler. Offensive. Egregious cross-dresser. Yes, that's true. I'm a dunce. I'm a dunce. Yes, that's true. He's a pedophile. He's a racist. He's a sexist. Yes, that's true. I smell. I'm a dunce. Offensive. Egregious cross-dresser. Yes, that's true. It was like Phil's an embezzler, and Phil invests his money in terrorism, and Phil's a drug dealer. So I'm having a dream that basically people are saying every heinous kind of thing they could possibly say about me, but because of who I am, people believe it.
Lost all my subscribers. I'm not monetized anymore. I shouldn't attack the bar free. I need my boyfriend.
I know prey when I see it. I've been a predator all my damn life. I'm built different than them. I'm cut from a different cloth. We ain't the same. There may be some gunfire, bloodshed, and bullets.
Dog. Damn. Blue flavor trickle. Dog.
Laying on your back, spreading your leg.
Dog.
I know prey when I see it.
Damn. Dog.
I've been a predator all my damn life.
Ain't no clapback videos. I'm looking.
I'm built different. We ain't the same.
Dog.
I'm touching them anytime I feel like it. I'm touching them now.
I come from scum. That's why I'm a Christian. I come from backwoods, incest-driven maniacs. I'm designed and built to bully
effeminate men.
We come from the bottom, and he raises us up, and he cleans us off. And from that point forward, I've been walking clean. Dog. Damn. Blue flavor trickle. Dog.
Laying on your back, spreading your legs. spreading your leg. I know, pray when I see it.
Damn.
I've been a predator all my damn life. I'm built different. We ain't the same.
I'll touch him anytime I feel like it. I'm touching him now.
Hold up, hold up, hold the hell up. I didn't want to forget those bargain bin fluffers who calls themselves detractors. No, not all of you fam. Season motherfucking 2.
I need my boyfriend.
Spread your leg,
I need my boyfriend.
Laying on your back.
I need my boyfriend.
Let me tell you something, brother.
Spread your leg,
I need my boyfriend.
I
need my boyfriend.
Spread your.
All right, last song, and I'm gonna go live.
I need my boyfriend.
I was eating until now.
Train being run up.
I basically came back home.
Hey fam, it's your girl.
I made
Samantha food,
and because of daylight savings, dude, I had to start early. And I had to start earlier than the early, so I can watch some clips first. Because I don't know what he's done recently, and I think he's been clowning a lot. So let's catch up. One more song. Let me just
subscribing to the channel.
Yeah, let me finish devouring. And also, thank you for 1 million views. Thank you. This channel has now hit 1 million. The big 1 mil. And in honor, I'm gonna play the bust.
Here's the thing.
Wait, this has 8,000 views. Wow, that's pretty crazy.
For accidentally beating off on camera. Now, luckily, nothing was shown. There was absolutely nothing exposed to the internet. It was just me doing my own things. I went viral for it. I just want the bust. Oh, man.
Bust.
Give me the monster.
Bust.
Wow, it's big.
Bust.
Oh my God, look how big he is. Oh my God. That thing is a monster. I just want the bust. Oh man.
Bust.
Give me the monster. Wow, it's big.
Talk about my
bust,
wife.
Bust. I just want the.
Why are you laughing?
I just want the. Give me the monster.
Jasper.
I just want her. I just want the.
Jasper just did that.
I ran robust.
Jasper.
I just want the
bust.
I just want the. I just want the. Give me the monster. I just want the. Wow, it's big.
Where did the load go?
I just want the
bust.
Oh man.
Bust.
Give me the monster.
Bust.
Wow, it's big.
Bust.
I just want the. I just want the. I just want the
bust.
I just want the
bust.
Oh!
Freddy, give me my intro.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing
Meerkat Mob.
Who?
welcome everybody. It's another live stream that we're doing. Thank you for the 1 million views. That's a lot of views. And of course, they're all stolen from Darkside Phil, because fuck him. He should start stealing some views too. Oh, what we got here? The best advice for anyone new to crypto. It's like literally 49 seconds long. Let's find out what this is. It came out a day ago.
It was easy to gamble through Cash App. If I lose $100, then at least I got involved. Nice. No, I appreciate it, man. That's a smart move to get involved here with crypto. So welcome to the Moon Gang. And yeah, best of luck to you. I would say the chat's right. You know, focus on buying ETH first. You know, when in doubt, buy ETH. That's the best place.
Oh, this is not a joke. I thought it was a joke, dude, because it's like a 49-second video. I thought he would say, no, the best advice is to not do it. Anyways, what has this guy been up to? Let's see some of the Snortster. The Snortomaniac. Let's see what's up. He plays Wolong again. Surprise, surprise. He didn't drop it. For some reason? I don't know why. He doesn't like it. And then there was a weird, like, incel type of thing that he did. Hey, big ups, Mr. Extravagant, dude. Thank you for the positivity and meaningful contribution.
I need my boyfriend!
It wasn't supposed to be this, but hope
congrats
you like it.
Congrats on 1 million views. Here is 0.00002 cents per view. Big ups
thank you,
Cat
thank
Mob
you.
Chat.
Thank you. Now let's get started with the positivity, right? And the meaningful whatever this is. I like these thumbnails with him with DSP looking old, because that's basically how he's gonna look when he's like 43. and he's barely staying awake. It's gonna be someday he's actually gonna fall asleep on stream and nobody's gonna be able to wake him up. It's gonna be just the DSP sleeping stream and everybody's gonna remember it and clip it and talk about it, and he's gonna just like fall asleep and actually just be asleep. So let's see these women type of thing, because this one is a short one, and let's get through the shorter ones first, because you never know when he's gonna start. Because he's supposed to start in 10 minutes, but he never starts on time. He usually starts like 20 minutes after he's supposed to. So yeah, we still have some time, I think. And let's see this. DSP gets weird about women dancing in Wolong and calls them jailbait. What? Why?
Long Dong Long is coming up.
Long Dong Long?
I can't wait to face Long Dong Long. Sounds fun.
Long Dong Long, dude.
Look at this drunkard.
Bro, look at his face. The moment he glanced at the screen and there was a woman there. So here he looks away at chat, because there's a woman doing suggestive poses or whatever it's called, like seductive. Right, and then he looks back and he sees a woman and recoils back at chat. Dude is terrified. What? This is the weirdest shit. And then he goes back to looking at chat. It's literally a cutscene playing that you're supposed to look at. He's terrified. It's so funny. It's so funny.
Long way.
I've never seen somebody so undesirable be so pussy whipped. Like, this dude couldn't cheat on his wife if he actually tried to. And he's just like afraid of looking at women.
Long Dong Long and Long Wang, the tag team
of course, and now we talk about dicks. Long Wang and Long Dong.
Team up to defeat the evil wizard.
Right, we gotta talk about cocks. We gotta negate the feminine energy by talking about dicks.
Oh, come on. It's so bad.
What is bad?
What the fuck is this? What does this have to do with the game?
What does this have to do with the game?
Seriously, what is this?
Why is he so fucking butthurt about this? He's such a weirdo. It's like the most normal fucking, like, dance. It's just like some traditional cultural dance, I assume. And then he has to be super weird about it.
The stupid king.
It's so fucking stupid.
My loins. It's either I'm aroused by the dancing or it is those three beef brisket tacos that I had for breakfast.
Perhaps what?
I should go to the bathroom just in case.
What? Bro, we made a dick joke and we made a poop joke. That's hot. What is funny, dude?
A wonderful display.
Dong Zhuo.
Tell me your name.
My name is Jailbait.
Jailbait.
Oh my gosh. I'm 12 years old.
What? Why though? Why? He needs to, it's like, because he feels like he has to make a joke about her as a woman and say something sexualized. So he's going to make every other joke ever to avoid making that specific joke he wants to make. Because that's the jokes old Phil was making. This dude is like, imagine being this fucking gin brain, man. This like a minute long cutscene of just women dancing to traditional music, and I assume they're doing a traditional dance. And he made like 1,000 fucking off-color stupid-ass jokes. They're not even funny. I get if there was if it was like Sam Hyde jokes where some of them land and they're like really funny.
Me woo.
But no, it was just stupid. God damn it! It was talking about dicks and dongs and wangs. This fucking dude. And this fucker. Let's see what else he got. Oh yeah, the video about the car is so ridiculous. I have to watch it. The video about the car, because this video is a joke, right? He was reacting to a video on DSP Reacts, the best channel on the internet, if it was the only channel on the internet, and all the other channels were taken down because they were like exposed to being groomers or something. So somebody wanted him to react to this video that is basically some dude flexing about his car, but it's a joke. It's a satire. So this is his reaction. And also, I think his chat is broken because nobody said anything there. Yeah, literally nobody said anything. I just refreshed it. But all right, I guess so. It's been slow.
$2.20 for gas? Where the hell is this?
Oh my God.
$2.20. It's over $4 here. When was this? Oh, 7 years ago. Okay, maybe. Shit, so
oh, look at this car, man. It's dripped out. It's dripped out. It's like Exhibit gave him the whole tuning. It's low as hell. It got that rims. Got the custom rims. It has literally no hood. This is so hot.
What's up, guys? My name's Robert Lovely. Today I'm going to show you my 92 Honda Civic with VTEC and Doge. All right, first let's talk about these curb fillers. I put these curb fillers on there. That way I know when I'm up next to a curb and I don't fuck up my nice wheels. These are a three-piece Rota wheel. And I got these lug nuts on there. What these lug nuts are used for is when a car pulls up next to you at a red light, you hit the button on the dash, and they shoot out, pop their tires, and that makes sure you always win.
What?
This stupid fucking bitch. He takes it literally, and he goes with it. It's like, what? This guy has things shooting out of his tires? He's so slow, man. He's so slow.
You shoot missiles out of your tires?
You shoot missiles.
To destroy someone else's tire. That's illegal.
That's illegal. Stop doing this. Stop shooting missiles. Who are you, James Bond?
You can't destroy someone else's tire.
Destroying the tires. And he goes full on Karen. He doesn't even like try and explain to you something. He's like, no, that's fucking illegal. You should stop doing it. There are consequences to your actions.
What the hell?
Oh, and he was dick riding Elon Musk on Twitter, but yeah.
I also got these lucky dice here.
I'll go watch that if I have time.
It's helped me get lucky when I'm out looking for pussy.
This gets a massive pop. This, I guess it was great. I guess that was a hot joke.
Oh. Don't F with VTEC, yo.
Never, yo. Yo, Mr. White. Don't F with my VTEC, dog.
What?
Big ups, Black Mage.
What the fuck? He actually just said that?
And this is like a massive, just
what?
A fake laugh. He said what? Pussy?
What the fuck? He's gotta be kidding. There's no fucking way this guy's serious.
Oh yeah, this might be him farming for shorts. So he can be like, oh, I didn't get this video. At least I got a short out of it.
0.5 liter Honda with VTEC. I got this,
and it's a piece of shit. Look at it; it's all corroded.
Specifically designed to fit my short throw dipstick.
Bro, there's no hood on the car. Say something about it.
Took the turbo off. Just put a straight pipe out the side. Upgraded intercooler.
This dude is so oblivious, man. He's like, I don't even know what to compare him to. He's like Phil. There's nobody else like Phil. To have such a massively high opinion of himself and then be this.
Cooler. Because I'm always overheating when I'm out racing Mustangs. We got a custom strut bar for when I'm going around corners.
He's like a... You remember this game? There was a Neighbors from Hell? Neighbors from Hell. And he's like the neighbor. The fat, stupid dude.
DSP's like when my dad first discovered the internet.
Most definitely. But when my dad first discovered the internet, he was actually better. So, fucking DSP is like this dude. This, like, oblivious dude. Except if he caught you, he couldn't beat your ass. Okay.
Something Mustang owners can't do.
Big ups, Cody Taylor.
Custom strut bar
we also
do.
Got this intake right here. I bought that at AutoZone, and it seems to make a lot of power. All right, let's talk about
That at AutoZone, and it makes power. Don't know how it works. Wait a minute. I just realized something. He has no hood.
Hey, there we go. No finally.
Hood on his car.
Yes.
If it rains, all his shit could corrode. So he spent all this money on the rims and these other additional parts. He has no hood.
It's a joke, Phil. It's a joke.
I got these drift stitches here, and I put those on there every time I beat a Mustang. That just helps me keep track of how many Mustangs I beat.
He really doesn't like Mustangs. What is his gripe with the Ford Mustang? He really hates them, huh?
I don't know either, but then again, I don't have a car, and I don't pay thousands of dollars for spark plug changes and shit like that.
Big old dent. What happened was I was passing a Mustang on the highway at 165 miles an hour. And I swerved and missed a pothole because my car is so dirt nasty low. And I sideswiped that Mustang. And after that, I noticed I had a big old rust spot here, but I said to hell with it. That's more weight reduction, so I let that bitch go. Unlike most Hondas, mine doesn't have any Bondo on it. I'd just rather let it rust out and keep the weight reduction. On top, we do have a roof rack here. And I use this for fat bitches when I go pick them up at the mall. Because when I put them in the car, they can't get out because the car is so dirt nasty low. Now, if you look at the back of my car, you'll notice I got a lot of stickers here. Each one of these stickers adds 5 horsepower, so I'll let you do the math. First one up here, we got Zip Tie Technician.
All right. For those who don't know me, all right, I will clear...
Oh, I forgot to say.
The TV Fund.
Yeah, TV Fund is success. It's success. I got a new display. I got like a 23.8-inch Asus for like 130 euros. It was hot. It's great. I'm enjoying it very much. But thank you anyways. This is going to the next TV fund. Big up Spikes.
Clarify here, I'm not into car culture at all. I'm not.
Oh, and here we have one of the stupidest Dark Side Phil takes of all time. One of the stupidest ones.
Friends in my lifetime who were super heavy duty in the car culture. They would buy cheap cars and soup them up just like this guy did. They would go to car shows. They would love the Fast and the Furious movies. They were so into car culture.
Okay.
I don't get it. I just don't get it. Like, of all the cultures you're going to be into. By the way, he's showing his license plate.
Okay. So?
Of all the cultures you're going to be into.
Okay.
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 I just don't understand car culture because it's the worst investment you can make in your life is to spend a bunch of money into a car. Cars, the moment you drive them off a lot, lose their value. The moment you mess with them, void the warranty. There's no point to doing it.
You void the warranty? It's like a laptop. This is the fucking one of the stupidest lame brain DSP takes of all time, man. This is Champions Dude telling you cars are the worst investment you can make. Cars from JPEG Man. From fucking bankrupt Mr. Phil, who can't even change his oil himself. And he pays a bunch of fucking money for spark plugs. And he gotta call his dad so his dad can assure him that he can get scammed and it's okay. Cause everybody fucking scamming is the worst investment. This literally the dude with zero investments in anything. Anything!
I don't understand it.
He had 2 properties. He didn't even fucking rent out the second one so he can make some fucking cash. Because he was too lazy.
I don't get it. I don't get car.
Doesn't get it. Nobody gets you, DSP. I think that's fair.
So.
Car culture.
Anyway.
What kind of culture is DSP a part of? Foodie culture? Is he a food fan? Is a fan of devouring? He can't cook for shit, though.
My drift stitching up front.
He's a fan of eating and consuming. He's a fan of consumer culture.
And that pretty much explains itself. I got braking necks all day. That explains itself pretty much, too.
What the fuck is that guy walking? Look what he's doing.
that's the point. Breaking necks. In case you didn't see, there was a guy in the back.
The moment you met...
That explains itself pretty much, too.
A guy with, like, a broken-looking neck.
What the fuck is that guy walking? Look what he's doing.
My favorite part of Fast and Furious is when the dealership calls Vin Diesel to tell him to change his oil. Cause as we all know, custom home mechanics need a car warranty.
Oh, dude, I think, yeah, that was in Too Fast, Too Furious. My favorite part is in Fast 5, when they go to the buyer's market for cars, and they have to pay a lot for spark plugs, and they buy a new Toyota Corolla. And then they jump off a building with it. Big ups, Black Mage.
What was that? Who is that guy? Why is that guy walking so weird? What's with him in the background?
Get best quality parts from there.
What a weirdo.
Sort of flush. A little bit offset, but ain't bad. All right, let's talk about the fuel we use in this car. We use 135 octane. That's what I get the most reliable tune out of.
Oh, I think I've had enough. This is just weird stuff. What's up, Junkie?
When are people going to get enough of him missing the point on everything? And they're just going to stop recommending him stuff to watch?
God.
When is that going to happen? Because I don't know the rest of the stuff he watched, because he only uploaded like specific select clips. But yeah, so... Oh, this was a hot segment. I've heard. I've been told. This is a hot segment about this is how you don't play is ruining his life. And basically, Evil AJ is the single person who led to his downfall. If it wasn't for Evil AJ, Phil would have like a bajillion views. And my neighbors are drilling at the moment at almost 7 at night. Can you hear this? Yeah, these dudes are fucking crazy. Well, we have to. We keep going. Do it live. He quit? He quit Modern Warfare? That's the fucking game I was telling you. I have no idea why he's playing. I guess he quit it now. Because it sucks. Because everybody else has been playing it while he was complaining about not liking Wolong and still playing it.
Oh, shit. I injected the healing. It did nothing. I just died anyway. As if I never injected the healing.
Nah, you would die anyways, dude. You have way too little time to respond.
No lag or anything.
Come on.
Guys. It's fine.
You would have been dead anyways.
Moving here. Best player on my team, by the way. Hilarious.
But if he's the worst player on his team, then it's a bad match. And he needs to rage quit and find a new one. But when he's the best player, everybody else sucks. So he needs to trash talk them. Oh, as you can see, he says in chat, another chill day. Let's see how chill it's going
to
be.
I saw him, I knew where he was, I set up, I go to fire. You're just instantly dead.
Yeah, you're instantly dead, dude. They shot you in the fucking face. That's what happens when they shoot you in the face. And he rage quit again. Now, when somebody says, Phil, you rage quit, you can send him this video. And then he's going to say, I didn't actually rage quit, I just like really wanted to do a Q&A.
All right, fuck this.
Let's do some Q&A.
Everyone's time. It's boring. It doesn't work right. It's fucking garbage. This season 2 just ruined the game, so I'm not playing it anymore. I'm completely done with it.
Oh, yeah. What was his ping? I think his ping is all right. It's not bad. Yeah, it has 60, like 50 latency. Oh!
His ping is literally on the damn screen.
Yeah, it's 50 ping. There's no lag. There's no lag. His brain is lagging.
I saw him. I knew where he was. I set up. I go to fire.
And again, there's nothing bad with being bad at the game, because everybody is bad at games at some point, but just like being a crybaby like that is not the best, you know? It's not very fun. It's not what he calls chill or meaningful, unless you find meaning in like clipping his downfalls, which is I guess what the trolls do.
It's boring, it doesn't work right, it's fucking garbage. They went this season.
Boring, it's garbage. They ruined the game. It's
fucking boring game like that.
Broken ass game.
Completely, oops, that's not what I wanted to do. A completely waste of everyone's time. There's no fun to be had there. Sucks. I really like multiplayer stuff. You know, there's nothing to play right now. There's just nothing to play. We've got to wait till Street Fighter 6.
There's nothing to play.
Over 2 months to wait for a multiplayer game.
He got a bunch of games that he didn't finish last year at some point. I remember Dying Light 2. That game got a lot of updates and like a lot of new stuff. he could go back and play that, but that also didn't get support. So he wage quit it.
Shit.
Or maybe he engage quit it because there was no engagement. And at the time, he was also caring about views, and now he realized there's no point in caring about views because there's no more views to be made off of those shitty gameplay videos. So I guess the new meta is React videos and some stupid, like, reviews so people can make fun of him for how bad he is at making reviews. Let's see, by the way, I want to see, for the sake of research, is there a single negative comment on that DSP Reacts, on that Joker video? Because that Joker review was god-awful. Yeah. It was like the bottom of the bottom of the bottom. And these thumbnails are just ass. It's just like sensory overload. And again, the colors are bad. I know I shit on him last time for the colors being bad, and they're still bad. I don't know who makes these, but it's probably Super Blind Man. Where is the there we go. Oh, this is not very hot either. I mean, it got like 2.2. So he saw, let's sort them by newest first. Why all of a sudden you're watching movies now, but before you didn't have time to watch them? What changed? It changed that he's getting views off of them, dummy. He's monetizing them, that's why. Move or movie review? Did he say move review? I guess maybe he did. But then when he approved the comment, he changed it. This says a lot about society. Can't wait for your review of the Snyder Cut. And then we get some pig explanation. I love Jonker. Imagine if DSP watched the fucking Kurosawa film. Yeah, that would be slow. Why is this in black and white? There we go. I saw Joker in theaters. It was disturbing. There you go. More of a recap than a review. And this is the only fucking dude that made it through that was pointing this out because he got a crown. That's why. And apparently a reviewer, that's literally what a reviewer does. They recap the story. Yeah, you Doug Walker enjoyer. That's exactly what a reviewer does. They tell you everything that happens in the movie for 20 minutes. And then they tell you they liked it because it was serious. It wasn't like a kid's movie. So yeah, this was ass. Don't watch it. Like, legit. There's nothing worth enjoying in that review. It's just 20 minutes of a dude who was probably drunk explaining to you the plot of a movie that he didn't completely get. With spoilers and all. He's just telling you all of it.
Right? Shit. Well, thank you for a $1.25 tip.
Well, you're welcome.
From Pickle Shit. What a great
pickle
name.
Shit.
Okay.
All of the dudes sending him fucking money have the most bizarre names. But I guess if you're gonna send him money, at least get your money's worth. Get him to say something really stupid.
For an hour, because I'm just too bored to fucking play that game. I'm seriously just not having any fun with
He's
it.
Like, bored. Dude, I thought your streams were meaningful and chill.
What happened to Call of Duty? It sucks. I closed it. I'm not playing it anymore. It's stupid. It's a waste of everyone's time, including mine. It sucks because, like I just said, I wish I had better multiplayer games to end the rotation.
Yeah.
Old School Street Fighter.
No, why not?
Capcom Fighting Collection, which is the actual good version of Old School Street Fighter. And everyone's still playing the 30th Anniversary Collection that's insanely laggy and a waste of time. So I can't play it.
If everyone is playing it, why is it laggy for you? It's almost like you're bad at it. I don't know. This is such a contradiction. Everyone is playing this game, but it's laggy. Why would they play it if it's laggy?
Crash, there's no point in playing it. It's like there's no multiplayer games right now.
No multiplayer. There's nothing to play. Okay. There you go. That's a hot take. And apparently he had another This Is How You Don't Play. Hold on. So this, in the last 3 days, he's had two of them. Because he's preparing for that Stuttering Craig fucking bullshit. And I hope they do that as fast as possible. I hope they did that right now. Or 5 hours ago or something. Or last year. He starts streams crying about, oh, fucking daylight savings. Dude, I'm not watching this. This is trash. He never doxed a single person. That's really cool.
Well, let me tell you something, brother.
Snort. Snort.
What do a leper and Phil have in common? Both scared of tips falling off.
His tip is gonna fall off, dude. Come on. Big ups, Castro.
Says after you do the podcast, create a command in chat linking to it, anytime a troll comes in and brings up something you talked about, you can just tell them to go there.
Yeah, the trolls know more than what you said on the podcast, DSP. You don't have to do that shit.
I don't know what you mean. You mean the specific episode from that day?
No.
Because that's really hard to do, because remember, I have to upload it.
No, that's later. Not what they mean, later, fucking moron. You know. They mean the Side Scrollers podcast. It's going to be the end-all, be-all of debunks, right? You're going to go there, tell your whole story end-to-end. You're going to answer all the hard-hitting questions as good as he can. And as good as the law allows him, of course. He can't be against the law. We've never done that. And, yeah, you can put a link in chat. So I guess people that don't like him can go watch it and still not believe him. Like, does he think that people that don't like him anyways are going to watch that and just believe the same shit that he's told on a podcast on a daily basis that the people don't watch him have already seen? What is he thinking?
And I have to change it every day. Red Gamer, okay, Red Gamer, now I get what you're saying. Red Gamer is saying once I appear
right
on the Side Scrollers podcast next week, once the podcast is done, then I should keep a link to the archived podcast. So when people bring up nonsense, all the detractor shit, I can say, hey, you want to talk about that bullshit? Go watch the podcast where I talked about it with these guys and have a link. Boom, done. We could possibly do that. I'll think about it.
Exclamation debunk. And that's what it's going to be.
Here's the thing, all right?
This is going to be so stupid. Like, for real.
It's only supposed to be about an hour and a half long. I get the feeling this is going to be an extra long episode.
Yes,
I don't see how they're going to address every nonsensical claim against me in the time frame. You know what I'm saying? There's been so much bullshit out there, and they don't know the backstories. They don't. They don't understand them because they're newcomers to me. They haven't been following me for years and years. They don't know exactly everything, you know, going on. So because of that, like, let's say, for example, all right, one of the things they brought up, actually, already on a week ago on their show, one of the things that was addressed was doxing. And they said, right, wow, it's messed up how much information has been doxed about.
In my dreams, this backfires on him, but it won't.
No, it won't. But he won't benefit anything from it anyways. He's going to have some trolls pretending to be new viewers and being like, hey, Phil, I never knew you were so positive and so meaningful before. And just telling him a bunch of shit that he's told before to his own audience. And he's going to be like, oh, you see, I'm not that bad. So, you know what is going to happen. You already know. You've seen it before.
Phil and his fan and everything. And then someone said on the show, oh, well, you know, that's because they say Phil doxed them. He's also guilty of doxing. So, you know.
Yeah, bro, you posted some dude's fucking driver's license in a Discord with a bunch of other degenerates. Come on. And one of those degenerates exposed you. Literally, like, one of the bigger ones. Anonymous, a little, like, I don't even want to say what.
Hypocrite here. Who's the bigger hypocrite?
Diaper wearer.
Never doxed a single person in my life. Not once. But again, so what would I have to do? Explain the backstory.
It was that's the thing. He has a weird thing with doxing where it has to be a public doxing, which means you go and you publish it publicly. His was a private doxing, which was a privately posted personal information. So if you post it to only people that you trust, that's a private doxing. That doesn't count. We only count the public ones. Hey, big ups, AMAC, for the 5 members, dude. Congratulations for the people that got them. And thank you for sending them.
I know is from my perspective, when I was accused of doxing a couple of years ago, I know that situation. So I would have to explain that situation to them of what really happened. But I've literally never doxed a single person in my life.
You posted a dude's driver's license.
Because my detractors say I did, even though I didn't.
I've literally seen his driver's license, dude. How else would I see it? And it was from your Discord. Come on, dude. Come on. There's like... The thing is, he tries to debunk stuff by just saying, trust me, bro. And those things he's trying to debunk have actual proof behind them. Come on.
Never happened. But that's what I mean. So what's the backstory? Oh, let's talk about that. And that's just going to lead to another story and another story.
So therefore, he was never doxxed too. Right? Because he put his own address on a fucking business card and he was giving it around. So he was never doxxed.
Story. So you could literally ask me one question that turns into 30 minutes. That's one question. You see what I'm saying? Wasn't it a former community member who fixed themselves? You mean doxed themselves? Again, If they ask the question, I'll answer the question on the show. It's been answered on here a million times. It's complete bullshit. The whole thing's fabricated. The whole thing's
fabricated.
It was a setup. Try to say that I docked someone when I literally never did.
Did you not post his driver's license?
Set up to do that.
Somebody else did.
Ahead of time. It was someone who was goaded into a situation by a moderator who also was a troll of mine, but didn't want to tell me and moderated for like 2 years. It's a long story. So there you go.
Oh, this fucking slimy bastard, man. He's so slimy and so greasy. And nothing's going to come out of it. That's why I'm so tired of talking about it. It's just like hyping yourself up for something that's not going to happen. It's like when some shit in politics happens and it's like people start hyping themselves up as if somebody's going to go to jail. Remember like when the Epstein flight list came out and they're like, dude, look, it's literally half of Hollywood and former presidents. I can't wait for them to go to jail. Right? Right? They're going, right? They're going? Are they going? They didn't go. So what else we got? Well, the dude is warming up in his jammies. He's doing exercise now. He's doing backflips and stretches. He puts the game on easy. Oh, did he put the game on easy? Let's see this one in Like a Dragon. I haven't watched any gameplay of that. I don't even know what kind of a game this is.
Oh my god, yo, this is insanity. There's like a million of these fucking guys.
Oh, he did this in Lost Judgment as well. Because he was just spamming stuff. He didn't know what it says, so he just answers with yes. That's how he signed up to so many credit cards, too. He just said, I guess yes.
Oh, no, I didn't want to do that. I switched to...
Oh, I didn't want to do that. It's by accident.
I mean to do that.
I got 14 credit cards and maxed them out by accident, dude. This shit sucks. Fucking government. Gonna try and fix it.
I can't even change it.
Ah, oh, come on. God, this is dumb. I didn't want to do that.
I don't want to fucking out.
Okay, so this is supposed to be on easy. And he is still getting clapped. Because this is supposed to be like an escort mission.
Even on easy.
Oh, he failed the escort mission.
Even on
get it?
Easy?
Yeah, because you don't do the thing you're supposed to do and then you're bad at the game. There we go. So he did that. Let's see him have a good segment on Twitter. Let's go to the Twitter / what's it called? The thing. They call me the guy. Do you know they call him the guy? I don't know why they would even call him like that. His name is not Guy. So there we go. He has huge important note. Oh yeah, daylight savings. There we go. And he's now been running music for 15 minutes. So then he was late by like 2 minutes. This dude is trash. Okay, so here they don't show up. Hey, we're actually starting the stream. He's asking, are you ready for this stream? Yeah. No items found. He was posting some like weird nostalgic shit. I guess. I remember that view across the street. Oh yeah, he made something about him. And we can't see this. Oh yeah, we can. Okay, so it's a picture of myself and Eddie Lee, aka the actual godfather of East Coast FGC. Thanks to Nang Baby recovering this picture. We were at University Pinball in Philly, cooking people. Picture has to be 23 years old, around 2000. And then DSP said, I remember that view across the street.
By putting the house address on publicly registered business info? Thoughtful face, thoughtful face, thoughtful face.
I guess it's down to definition, dude. I don't know. I don't do that shit, so it doesn't really... Like, I don't know between the definitions. But yes, he's like literally all his info is out there that he put out there. So let's see him live. What is up with this dude?
Funny running into you here. Didn't plan on seeing you, but hey.
Hey, we have the false intro again.
Mi casa es su casa. How you doing? Welcome to the Level 1 podcast, where we are busy having fun down here in the dungeon of Level 1. I set up this border this morning, and I was like, what color do I want to do for the show today? And I'm like, how about purple? Eh, it kind of blends in.
Sup, Meerkat, did you make the beat for Easy Money?
Yeah, I did. I used some samples and shit, but I did put it together. As in, you can't find the actual beat anywhere else. It's limited edition.
It all works. It actually is pretty cool. How are you all doing today? I hope you're doing well. Welcome to a new week, right? It's Monday. Today's the 13th of March, 2023. Of course, I'm Darkside Phil, and I welcome you here to my show, as always, every single day. How are you? And I hope your weekend went well. I hope everyone had a good one. Coming off of a lot of interesting stuff, to say the least. You know, a lot of stuff happened last night. If you guys aren't aware, it was a very busy night.
What happened?
Or maybe you don't care at all, in which case you kind of missed out on all the stuff.
Oh, he's talking about his own show? I guess.
I'm actually trying to see what screen capture I took for today's news segment. But last night, first of all, was the Oscars.
Oh, Oscars. Sadly, he cares about it so much.
No one got slapped. And because no one got slapped, I had nothing to tweet about. I did not get a new viral tweet at the Academy.
Oh, my God.
If you remember last year.
Oh, my God.
Out to the Academy about their insanely bad response to the Will Smith slap of Chris Rock.
Did I ratio them?
Viral tweet ever. It exploded. People absolutely loved it. And it amounted to absolutely nothing. But
yeah, so?
It was just funny that of all people, I was the person who had the viral tweet about it.
It doesn't matter. That's why you had a viral tweet about it, because it doesn't matter who tweeted this out. Anybody could have done it. I could have done it. And it could have got the same amount of tweets, and the same shit would have come out from it.
But this year, nothing like that. But
nothing.
A pretty crazy year for the Oscars with the movie Everything Everywhere All at Once taking like 11 awards, including Best Picture. We'll talk a little
swag
bit about that, only because I'm kind of interested in the movie and I don't know much about it. And then in addition to that, last night, if you're not aware, was the season finale of The Last of Us television show over on HBO Max. And first of all, I'm going to do a full review, not only of episode 9, the final episode, but also of the entire series tonight over on DSP Reacts, my React channel. All right, so if you want my full-fledged thoughts on that, you get over there tonight after my late stream. I'm actually going to record and upload it over there. But I want to just kind of glance over it a little bit. Just kind of gloss over. I don't want to give you my full thoughts. I mean, what's the point of me doing a full review of it if I'm going to talk about it on the podcast today? That wouldn't make much sense, would it? So what I'd like.
Yeah, but then again, we talk about stuff multiple times throughout the week. Exactly the same type of shit. So yeah, it's not like it's not your style to be repeating yourself.
What I'd like to do is just give you a brief synopsis of what the episode was, and let.
And we're gonna get a 20-minute long summary of what happened in the episode.
Give you a very brief thoughts, and then tell you, hey, you want my full thought out? You know, fully fleshed out thoughts, head over there tonight. Okay, so we got a couple things there to talk about today. But today also, all right, we're gonna talk about my upcoming podcast appearance.
Oh my God, again? Podcast. Again? What more are you gonna say? What more do we have to say? Just go on it. Talk to the dude. Disappoint everybody again. Come on.
This week, I'm finally on this very show.
Bruh.
The date and time of that appearance, because here it is Monday, and I need to tell you guys what I'm doing for the rest of the week so you know what to do and where to be. And there still has been no formal announcement. Actually, they had said originally.
Oh, so he's going to do it first.
My appearance today.
He wants all that swag.
On the show.
He wants all the clout.
I think there's various different reasons for that.
Because they're scared of the trolls.
Which I'm going to discuss on my own show.
Yeah, there we go. Okay. There we go. So, it's going to be the paranoia cast.
That's going to be a segment. We're going to talk a little bit about that, okay? Because I know you guys want to know about that. You want to know what's going on. What's the deets? Give me the deets. So I'm going to give you the deets on that. And that's about it. I don't have too much else. Like, there's nothing in gaming news. I was checking, and there's not too much going on in gaming news right now or anything to really talk about. So I feel like between those topics and everything going through there, we'll have a good amount of stuff to discuss on the show. And, of course, as always, we'll have some open Q&A and the light. You know, today we're doing a chill streaming day of Hogwarts and Like a Dragon Ishin.
Oh, this is gonna be so bad. Yesterday was stressful, dude. At this point, there's no video game that I would like for him to play. He should just give up, man. He murders everything. He sucks the soul out of every video game he touches. It's almost incredible.
Full day of Wolong Fallen Dynasty. So there you go. All right, so welcome to the show, everyone.
It was stressful. Why not drop the game? Like you said.
Chill stuff today. Daylight saving time went into effect yesterday.
Yes, it did.
And I noticed that a lot of people were late. Because
a lot of people were late. Show up on time, dense. Show up on time, you fucking idiots.
I came to the show.
They were late.
Visibly tired. Like, I actually watched back the podcast.
She was visibly tired.
And looking at my own face, I was like, oh my God, like, I looked bad, right? Like, I looked like my face, like, you could tell I was barely awake, my eyes. I couldn't even keep them open.
Oh, yeah, you sure.
A second cup of coffee to even.
Whoa, he had to drink coffee to play video games. Feel bad for me.
Sleep, and then I had to get up an hour earlier.
It's an hour earlier. People get up at fucking 5 o'clock to go to work, you fucking moron.
So, here's what happened last night. Listen to this, okay? So it's time to go to sleep, and it's the usual routine. We get Jasper into the bedroom, and luckily, I brushed my teeth. Cause here's the thing: sometimes I'll have like a drink next to me in bed or something like that. Depending,
ooh.
I brush my teeth right before I go to sleep. But in this case,
what kind of a drink? we drink. We sipping in bed.
Like way tired, so I'm gonna brush my teeth before I even lay on the bed, just to be safe. Okay. So I brush my teeth, and
I love the wave of gin in chat. I almost feel intoxicated.
I was doing it, approving some comments, reading through some comments and things like that on videos, looking at performance. And for example, the YouTube short from yesterday, the one about lockpicking in Oblivion, has done pretty good. Over 3,000
Hey, performance is good. Views. Whoa, it's a minute long thing, DSP. Give it a break.
Which is pretty good. Usually my shorts don't do that well in that short of a period.
Okay.
Of time,
but how much are you getting paid for shorts?
I haven't really.
How much do they make?
On it, so probably everyone who wanted to see it has seen it. We'll see what happens with it in the future. But anyway, like, that's about as far as I got. Like, seriously. I was like looking around. I'm like reading, approving comments. I look at the video views. I don't know what happened. I woke up this morning. Whoa. And that usually never happens. Like me, everyone. Well, I've talked about this over the years. For me, I don't usually just go right to sleep. For me, at night, it's actually sometimes hard for me to go to sleep.
You got all the voices in your head, like Randy Orton.
I'll watch stuff at night, or I'll skim through videos, or, whatever.
He's getting schizo time at, like, 3 a.m. I'm successful, you guys. I'm successful. Please tell me I'm successful.
Done. In
fact, his brain is screaming.
And, woke up in the morning, mostly woke up this morning, because Kat had to go to work. So I woke up when she was getting up to go to work, and I was like, oh, what time is it? I start looking around. I'm like, what the? Wow. Whoop. So I actually got like almost like half as much sleep as I would normally get yesterday. And then last night I got like extra sleep.
Bro, okay.
I woke up this morning.
Good. You still look like shit, though.
What happened?
You still look like ass.
Right? What did you get the delight?
Telling you how
that knocked me out.
How energized he is.
And I was like,
extra sleep.
I feel good. I actually feel very energetic today. Like I jumped out of bed and I was like, oh.
This is literally a child. Like this is like a child story. Oh, yesterday I didn't sleep very well, and last night I was so tired, I went to bed and I was like, shoop, I fell asleep. And then I wake up this morning, and it's like, whoa, I sleep like 1 week. Whoa, I slept so much. Yes, Timmy, go do your fucking homework.
This is what it feels
like. And go back to special needs class.
Like to have energy. I forgot. I used to be young and spry, be able to jump out of bed every morning like super pep.
Oh,
I haven't done that in a while. Mia
Kat's boyfriend
okay.
Material.
I get it.
I need my boyfriend.
Thank you, Swaggy Davis Jr.
Any better than yesterday.
No, you still look like ass.
Better this morning. I'm like, this is excellent.
How did he look yesterday? Let's vibe check him.
Rather than feeling very slow and sleepy.
Does he look like a boyfriend?
That's a good thing, right? So, yesterday, first of all, let's talk about yesterday.
There is internet. Internet exists. Hey, there we go. We're back up. Refresh. Hit that F5 like Brock Lesnar. Mash that F5.
What I have with you guys is as follows.
Give it the Brock Lesnar.
I don't like the game.
And we back to Wolong. He doesn't like the game for episode 56,000.
Abundantly clear publicly to everyone. I don't like Wolong, Fallen Dynasty.
We get
it's
it.
It's funny because I was talking with a few people about it, and one person says to me,
He was talking to human beings.
It's funny because I think Wolong is the only game that could have possibly made Phil admit that Sekiro was good. I don't feel that I hated on Sekiro so much that I ever said it wasn't good. What I said was, it's probably the weakest entry from FromSoft because it's a one-trick pony game where everything is about the parry, correct? I mean, yes, there's special trick weapons or whatever they're called in that game, but for the most part, it's about parrying everything, correct? So, a lot of people felt that me kind of hating on Sekiro when I played it several years ago when it was new was unfair, but now that I'm playing Wolong...
He was talking to people in Discord, dude.
Sekiro, they're like, wow, all this praise for Sekiro. Well, what it is it's comparison, correct? Right? It
really correct? Stop saying correct, dude. I will
is
hurt something that is not alive in a video game.
Five best FromSoft games. Okay,
dude, like, stop. If I haven't noticed the tiny children t-shirts he wears, don't attract attention to them. It pisses me the fuck off. Look at the tiny ass fucking baby boy t-shirt.
I really
look at how short it is.
Bloodborne, you know, some of the Dark Souls, and hell, even Elden Ring, I actually think are better than Sekiro, just being honest, okay? But basically, it's funny because now I'm playing...
Wolong had too many rice eaters, dude.
Hey. Be nice. My girlfriend is a rice eater, and she makes amazing rice. So you can suck it. And we don't even operate a household, correct?
It makes me realize how much better FromSoft is. It's their
yeah, dude. Quality. They made these games.
Everything has a designer's hand.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
yes. It's like saying Rockstar Games are the best at making GTA fucking games. Of course they are. They're making these games. They pioneered them.
FromSoft game. You know,
fucking moron.
Are well designed in order to add challenge, surprise, wonder, exploration. You know what I'm saying? Like everything there is
Dark Souls 2.
When you're playing Wolong and you're walking to an area and you're like, there's an enemy over here, there's an enemy over here. Oh, enemies spawn out of nowhere and attack you from behind. Sometimes you'll walk into a room and a bunch of enemies attack. Another time you walk into a room, they don't even aggro to you. And you did the same thing twice. It's just not consistent. It's definitely reeks lack of polish compared to FromSoft. So it's funny that I'm playing Wolong and I'm calling this out and people are like, wow, you're really like kissing Sekiro's butt. It's like, no, I'm just being honest. Sekiro is a much better product than this game is. And the reason that people are really kissing Wolong's butt and saying it's an 8 out of 10 is because there's no game like this recently. Elden Ring was the last one. That was a year ago. The other ones last year, like Thymesia and shit, those sucked. So this is the first one, you know, in a while. And what it is there is definitely a community, a group of gamers that love this genre. And they have to play this game and kiss its butt. They just have to.
What?
They have to say it's so good.
No,
it's
they don't.
From an objective standpoint, me comparing apples.
Bro, this dude is just, again, he's fighting. He's shadowboxing people that don't fucking exist, man. These people, they feel like they have to buy a game and kiss its ass.
Style of
aren't those people the FromSoft sexuals that he hates so much that actually dislike those games because they're not made by FromSoft?
Games in the same genre.
Meerkat Phil is buff, dude.
I know, dude. He's about as buff as a soft cock.
This ranks as one of the worst.
I'm probably more buff than him.
Of issues,
and I'm the skeleton man.
That is unacceptable. Just the fact that the draw distance in the game is so bad is one of the things that's just absolutely ridiculously unacceptable.
Why are you still playing it, though?
I couldn't tell you another video game I've played in the last 5 years that the draw distance is so short. Okay?
I don't know.
That's just sad.
I need to get
that's just one of the many problems the game has.
Super Blind Man to fact check you on this.
All right. But I have this agreement with you guys that I will continue to play the game and suffer through it as long as you guys
hint hint
watch, engage, and support. That's
so
Bernal House is a pig, cat, and cow.
So this is the three-pronged plan. Watch my videos, and give me money. Sounds good? So that kind of sounds a lot like a buy-in.
That's the agreement.
That's the agreement. It's an agreement. This slimy fuck.
If you guys continue to show up and you know, make this
the agreement
worthwhile for me through the suffering of me playing
this the suffering,
game, I'll continue to play it. So yesterday was
I thought you were getting older, Phil.
Agreement. And people showed up. They absolutely engaged and supported. It was only a one stream day. And it was awesome because people absolutely made up for that with the engagement and support on that stream, and I really appreciate that, because you know, not having two streams, it can hurt. And
oh yeah, he literally got a whale.
Okay,
there was a whale, gave him like $100 and something, didn't it?
As for the gameplay,
right?
It pissed me off. You know, I'm doing a stage where it's basically you're on a river. Your goal is to cross the river.
We are skipping this. I don't like the summary segments. Summarizing gameplay stuff is like explaining what happened in your dream. It's never as interesting as the actual thing.
Throw a fireball that boom. It's blatant bait to try to say, oh, we stacked on as much as possible. But did you actually test it? Did you polish it? Did you see if it's fair or entertaining? Or did you just throw shit into there? And that's how the DLC felt. That's exactly how this whole fucking game feels. It doesn't feel like anything has a guided designer's hand that says, oh, here's a fun challenge. Here's a fun room we set up. It's just, here's a bunch of shit. Just fucking deal with it. If it works or not, we don't really care. And that's sad. So, I really don't like the game, but I'm toughing through it. So yesterday, I beat an entire story stage. I did 2 side quest stages, and then I beat the half of another story stage.
Wow, that's great, Phil. Great job. You worked really hard yesterday.
If I beat a stage and a half every stream, if you do the math, okay, that technically means likely we've got like 4 or more streams left. Yes, I know. 4 more streams.
Bro.
Oh my god, you'll be playing this for weeks.
I've never seen somebody hate doing something so fucking trivial and cry about it so much and make it about so many things. He's cried more about the game than he has actually played it.
Oh, I know. Listen, I know. I hear you. I'm there with you.
Like, this is how you don't play of this game. Better have these clips as well. Because this is to the point. He fucking hates this game.
And
he didn't even used to get money playing it. He was getting like $30, $40, $50. And then he made that 20-minute video.
It's a game of suffering.
God damn it.
Again, since people are showing up and supporting, I'm going to keep playing it. If that changes, it would be hilarious if I get to the end and then, like, the game dies. I'd be like, what did I waste my time on? Right? But I guess we'll see.
What do you mean the game dies?
Okay.
You mean people stop giving him money? It would be bad if I play it a lot and you stop giving me money.
That's not
the case. That rocks.
And I sincerely hope that, you know, the game continues and you know, maybe there's a payoff at the end. Maybe there's an amazing ending. There's not going to be an amazing ending. Spoiler alert. There's absolutely no way with a game like this. There's no way. But I'll keep going. All right. So anyway, the stream, I would argue the stream went well. You got what you wanted. You got the rage out of me, which is what you want out of this playthrough. And it was well engaged, well supported. Everything was good on that stream, okay? I didn't stream last night because I had to film my private patron.
Private patron videos.
Which were fun. It was a good
The OnlyFans videos.
Stuff for Slayer, some K-pop stuff. And
there was Phil, can you show me your foot?
There are a couple patrons that their private reacts are literally that. They're private reacts. They're meant just for them, and that's fine. You have to understand it. These are private videos, and if these people choose to make them public, that's their prerogative. They own the video once they pledge to my Patreon. But, you know, some people say, nah, I just want to keep it to myself, and I appreciate that too. There's some interesting topics.
It's so ridiculous, man, bro.
The last several months that
this is
those videos just stay privatized because people just want
privatized.
Perfectly fine. So.
Okay, this is the weirdest dude on the internet. There's nobody weirder than this. And I don't mean like a sex freak or some weird fucking dude. This is like a
extra time.
There's nobody as weird as him in these very specific ways.
Didn't really have time to work on any kind of tax stuff or business stuff behind.
Oh, that sucks, dude.
Is I posted up the threads so that if you are a channel member over on DSP Reacts, as of now, you can post up the videos for next week's show. That is DSP versus the internet. So I posted it. I did as much as I could to signal boost this. So I posted up the
thread. So he spammed it.
On the community tab of DSP Reacts. All right. I did a schedule update post that also said, hey, this is live. Go post. And then I even did a YouTube short.
Whoa.
Watches the shorts over there. They don't get attention. So, you know, it's not a big deal. I just hope that basically the signal got boosted.
Pick the ear.
People now know. Oh, okay.
We're going to look at it.
Remember. It's first come, first serve. If you're a member on DSP Reacts, literally
Derek always is first come.
The earlier you
always
the higher chance I'm going to watch your clip on the show. Something that sadly
we're picking the face again.
Literally in the last few hours before the show we're posting up, I'm like, there's no way I'm watching those videos on the show, you know? So again, if you're a member over there on DSP Reacts, that's youtube.com/channel for third party. I did one or two other quick things, you know, behind the scenes. And that was it. That's all I really had time to do. So what this means, just for pure clarification.
Hey, big ups, Mr. for the sub. That's a very complicated name.
I have to take another day off. Not day off, excuse me.
Yeah, because he got to do more taxes.
Probably next weekend. Probably like Sunday night. I'm going to have to take another night off. And I'm going to spend that entire
Stop rocking.
Numbers and finishing up.
Stop rocking.
So it's done.
Please.
Submitted and ready to go.
He's rocking way too much today.
Interrupted anymore because we got some busy stuff coming up. If you guys aren't aware, just this month we've got Resident Evil 4 Remake, my Q&A show. So we've got all this stuff already happening that's going to also be jumping into my gameplay schedule. So it's like, dude, I can't be having even more streams away later on in the month once all that happens. So next weekend.
Sounds good.
Your boy says it only took my accountant 1 hour to do my taxes. Good for you. Good for you.
You don't run your own business. Do you operate a business? Do you run a household? Do you have a crippling addiction to mobile games? Yeah, I don't think so.
Really? I miss those days. I totally miss those days where I used to be able to just do things like this.
It's one of those days where you don't want to wake up. Everything is fucked. Everybody sucks.
All these revenue streams that I have to count every dollar. Can't. Oh, you forgot a dollar. Oh, you're in trouble. No, you got to count every dollar.
Every dollar.
You got to break it down.
Break it down.
You know, everything.
then write an extra zero in the end.
Basically, dot your I's and cross your T's.
One zero less, maybe?
It's a pain in the butt.
It's a pain in the butt.
It's a ton of work. So... yeah, it's got to get done. And so probably next weekend, we're doing that on the weekend. Okay, just so you know. So that'll be like three straight Sunday nights where with no live streams on the late night last night.
Okay.
Okay, cool. All right. So all that being said, it was a productive night last night.
Okay.
Today is a chill day. I'm very excited for today to be a chill
day. Oh, he's going to get to relax. He's so stressed out, you guys. He played video games and then slept 1 hour less.
That's how we can talk about The Last of Us.
This is the type of shit you talk about before you start the video.
First of all,
he doesn't know anything about the Oscars. He doesn't watch movies.
No, Brendan Fraser taking Best Actor for The Whale.
There you go. It's not crazy. He's a good actor.
Box office in like the 90s and early 2000s.
Shout out to The Mummy.
He's like the generic Well, I guess rom-com. He was in a few of those.
Rab-cab.
Mummy. Who would have thought all these years later he would have gotten a Best Actor award? You never would have thought. And he has.
Oh, yeah. DSP loves The Whale.
And so
he loves The Whale. And he loves The Whale tail.
Nowhere and come out like that. That's nuts. Now, I've not seen The Whale. I'd be interested in...
But you have some.
You know? I mean, listen, I'll be honest with you guys. I always liked Brendan Fraser.
Everybody did.
Like, he wasn't taken as a serious method role actor guy. You know what I mean? But I enjoyed his work. I always... You know, he has that impression that he's kind of probably like a nice guy. And I would like to actually see The Whale. But I don't know how I'd watch it, but I would like to
look at your PayPal.
The other big winner.
They're screening it for free.
All at once. The film that won 11 awards.
Whoa!
Swept. Best actress. Best supporting actor. Right? Freaking the actor who played Short Round and Data in classic 80s movies like Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom and Goonies is now back 40 years later winning Best Supporting Actor awards at the freaking Oscars. That's crazy, man.
There you go.
It's freaking crazy.
It's the biggest comeback since that movie that Derek watched.
Okay, and...
Bleh.
So, it was crazy Academy Awards, to say the least.
Yeah, now, pretty crazy. You don't care about it. Why are you talking about
really
it?
I would really be interested in seeing Everything Everywhere All at Once. But this sadly, is kind of like... This is the symptom now of everything going digital and having a subscription service, okay? It used to be these movies would come out, and now you'd be like, oh, now you can just immediately go digitally and watch it somewhere for like $5. I can't even find it. Like, I'm looking. I look on Amazon Prime. They're not there. I look on HBO Max. They're not there. Amazon Prime's like, oh, you can watch it. If you want to pay like $25, you can buy the movie.
I don't want to buy the movie.
Just pirate it like everybody.
See what it is. Maybe these are movies I can watch and review.
Internet.
DSP Reacts. They're Academy Award winning movies. Why wouldn't I want to see them and review them for DSP Reacts? I think that would be great content for the channel. But there's no way I can't find it. You know, is there a way to...
He can watch it in the theater, but he doesn't want to.
Kind of a reasonable situation.
So ironically, he's basically the type of person who streaming services were made for. The type of consumer that made streaming services a thing. The dude who doesn't want to go to the theater.
Or do I have to subscribe specifically to the one, you know, movie studio service? Is it Paramount Plus? Is it MGM Plus? Is it fucking, you know...
Brazzers Plus?
Indie movie studio Plus?
Is it, what was the other one? Cherry Pimps Plus?
How do I get it?
Derek is a frequent user of that one.
I want to just...
He doesn't have the Plus one, though, because he's broke.
And now it's changed. So I'm curious how to do it. I don't know. If anyone knows, if you know this is the avenue to watch those movies, I would love to actually watch them now and review them for you guys. I would absolutely... like. That's super interesting to me. These movies are hot. These movies are interesting right now because they just won Academy Awards. I would absolutely like to watch them. But I need
so?
To know what's the avenue. How do I...
Google it, you fucking retard. You fat fucking slob. Google it. Look it up.
I see it. Not download illegally.
Fucker. You stupid fucking bitch.
Right. Someone says rent it on YouTube. Can you do that? How would you rent it on YouTube? How would that even work?
It's on Netflix.
Would you do that through the YouTube?
There you go. Literally. Literally. Look at this. Look at this. Huh? Watch Everything Everywhere All at Once. Netflix.
It's my YouTube app. It's open.
Fat fucking moron.
How would I even go about doing this?
Whoa.
I don't have Apple TV.
Whoa.
I don't have Netflix.
Then fucking... jump off a trampoline.
Okay, let's take a look. So I open search. Let's say Everything Everywhere All at Once. I click on it. I see the trailer.
Bro.
This... Watch with Showtime or buy. See?
Oh, maybe it's in my region. It's on Netflix because it's special. You can, dude. Just
watch with I don't want a Showtime subscription. I don't want a Showtime subscription. I don't need it. Okay? But it says buy. When you click on buy...
I'm so tired of this, dude.
$7. Oh, excuse me. $25.99. $26.
Bro, it's... No.
I'm paying $26.
You don't have to.
So now I click on the whale.
And we click on the whale.
Buy only. I click on buy. $26. You see? You see the point I'm making? Like, you can't even, like, watch this shit. It's very frustrating, man. It is.
This dude is so stupid.
Watch the goddamn movie, and how do you watch it?
Honestly, this stupid human being.
Showtime. I don't want a Showtime subscription. Watch on Apple TV. I don't have Apple TV. Why do I have to download 17 services in order to just watch a new movie?
Because you didn't go and fucking see movies in the theater. And all the people like you didn't. So now we got a million fucking streaming services.
It's actually gotten worse. What I used to have...
There you go.
TV. This is a long time ago. I used to have... Now they don't want to pay... And no, don't... Do not, please, do not say, oh, rip the movie. Don't send me the illegal fucking movie or anything.
Don't send me the illegal movie.
A viable way to watch these easily.
And then pay for it, you fucking moron.
I'm not paying 20-some dollars.
I'm not paying. Well, then fucking download it. But I'm not doing that either.
Because... they won Oscars.
It's against the law.
Oscar winners, because that's a good thing to review for DSP Reacts, I feel.
Right. Well, and he's going to spend so much time trying to find the movie to the point where the movie's not going to be relevant anymore.
I don't want to waste a ton of money. So let me know. Please share.
Let me know.
Okay. Let me know, and we'll go from there. So by the way, it sounds like my wife is leaving for work, which means...
Oh, what does it mean? We opened the door for Jasper. So Jasper Kitty can come in and ruin the stream. Jasper Kitty. Jasper Kitty. Jasper.
Jasper.
Jasper Kitty.
The Jasper Kitty.
So Jasper can join us today.
Sir Jasper.
It's always good to have Jasper in the office.
No, it's not. Jasper fucking sucks. He's boring as hell. He always derails the stream. He's stupid. and you make him seem like he's way more interesting than he actually is. Jasper fucking sucks. Change my mind. You can't. I'm too biased.
Awesome furry friend. Want to come up here and say hello to everyone? Want to come up here, buddy?
There we go. This is now a Jasper segment. Because Jasper is so fucking cool, we need to derail ourselves to slap ourselves in the fucking...
That's it.
Fuck. He wants to... That's the thing, man. Some people are just perpetual fucking victims like that. Where it's everything constantly goes against them and they have to complain about it. And he's... Like, the instance right now. He didn't fucking... do anything about it. He just asked for help. That's just stretching his hands. Please, please help me. Help me.
He'll do it when
with everything, perpetually, for like 40 years straight.
He's in here now.
Completely helpless, worthless, useless. Welcome.
Okay, buddy, you're welcome in the office today for Hogwarts. There's kitties in Hogwarts. Yeah.
Cool. So you saw his tail?
You saw Jasper's tail.
He's welcome today.
Cats have tails. Breaking news.
So, yeah, if anyone has ideas of how to watch these movies, I'd like to watch...
Now, the camera wheel. Shit. Yeah, we got it. We got it. We got it. Let's go to live.
And then we're going to do the third trial, which is essentially these trials are the big story points of the game. So we're going to do the third one and finish that up. And that's going to head us into the fourth and final season of the game. Now, I talked with Kat, my wife, about this. And basically, oh, really? Nienna says, I just Googled it. You can't even rent Everything Everywhere All at Once yet. All you can do is buy it or get Showtime plus, 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 whatever the fuck it's called.
Are you trying to tell me there's no free trial for it where you can just watch the movie and then cancel the free trial?
That is
all of the services work like that. Dumb. That's pretty dumb.
Think of how they could have capitalized, how dumb this is. They could have just immediately had it available for rent. And
hey, actually, yeah, I didn't see your super chat. That's good that you pointed it out. I'm going to replay it.
Oh!
Bernal House is a pig, cat, and cow.
There you go. Wait, cow? Pig, cat, and cow. Who is the cat? Oh, the lol cow? But then he is the pig also. Wait, I'm not following.
Had 1 million rentals last night when it won all the awards.
But cat is the cow?
How stupid
but is that? Cat is the cat. We're all collectively just going crazy.
So today it's Hogwarts.
No, she's a horse, dude. She's a horse.
I love the horse. Last night, and she says this final part, like this fourth part of the game.
Too many animals.
There's the least amount of side content, the least amount going on. It's actually relatively fast moving. But once you get to like the fourth trials...
Meerkat, you're not being a boyfriend.
What more do you want me to do? Come on. I'm keeping you company. I'm keeping you nice and warm and feeling good. Pastor touching me.
I'll touch him anytime I feel like it.
And it's all good. What more do you need me to do?
Alley of the game, it takes a while.
Swaggy like, Davis Jr.
The game is kind of lengthy. So I talked to her. She's like, probably three more streams. Like today and maybe two more streams and we're done with Hogwarts. Okay? That's good. That means that next week we'll finish the game. And that means we can move on to new content for like the later half of the month, which I'm happy because the game's been incredibly lengthy. And I do want to address something.
What are we going to address? We're going to have a State of the Union segment. Criticism. My fellow Americans.
Believe it. Listen to this. I'm getting criticism because the last one to two streams of Hogwarts, people are actually saying I'm rushing through the game and not taking my time and I'm missing a bunch of stuff. Okay? Now... Let's address this fairly, shall we? Let's address this fairly.
You're already not going to address it fairly because you mocked it already. People are giving me criticism for, can you believe this? Like, get a load of this. I'm rushing through the game. So this is not going to be a fair addressing since we're already biased.
So my playthrough of Hogwarts so far, all right, is 39 hours long.
But you said you enjoy games like this because you can take your time. That was an actual example that you gave with Hogwarts. Exactly. Multiple streams, multiple times. You can find it actually very easily if you wanted to.
39 hours, all right?
This so, yes.
Has been going on for over a month. It started in February. We are now at mid-March.
Okay.
The playthrough's not over yet. Viewership has massively diminished and dwindled for this playthrough.
Okay, so views...
People are expressing their interest in seeing other new games.
Like what?
Look, we get it. We know what the game
is. You just said there's no games coming out.
It's great, but move on to other stuff. This is the impression. This is the feeling I'm getting overall from my viewing audience. Okay? They're telling me, listen,
They're telling me, dude. Where the voices in my head.
Overstated to I have voices in my head. They talk to me. They understand. They talk to me.
Because it's been too long. So, you know, can you move on to other stuff? Like, well, I'm not going to move on to other stuff till we finish the game. All right?
So we got to rush.
Take a look at the last couple
of... We got to ruin the playthrough. It's not going to be valid. Streams of it.
Take a look at what I've been doing. I outright told you guys, listen, I am not going to be doing the open world collectathon stuff anymore. I'm not doing the Merlin trials. I'm not going to be doing any pages floating around or anything. You know, we're past that. Basically, I've gotten the level 3 lockpicking now. Like, I feel like I've done enough of the collectathon stuff. All I want to do is the main side quests and the main story missions, and that's it.
This sounds fair to me.
I'm doing, but even then, I'm getting criticism. So here's one of the big things. Last stream, there was a story-based mission where you drink a polyjuice potion and you end up looking like the headmaster of the school, Sirius Black. And you walk through the school, and there's a little bit of funny dialogue with a teacher who thinks that you're the teacher. Actually, there's two or three teachers who you talk to, and they think that you're the actual headmaster, and you just kind of have a fun conversations, and then you kind of move on. Well, apparently...
Bro, this is what the interview is going to be like. He's going to wear down Craig with a bunch of fucking worthless information and, like, over in-depth explanations of menial, meaningless, worthless things. It's going to be so fucking bad.
Conversations to have been had with other students along the way. Now, they weren't flagged as important. They weren't actual cutscenes that just happened. I guess they were optional. That you had to talk to the students. People were like, he missed one of the best missions of the game. He didn't talk to every student. It's like, well, I didn't make the game.
What?
I didn't know that. I honestly didn't know that there were meaningful, funny conversations that I missed.
Meaningful.
You know? They weren't even marked.
Were they meaningful, like, you guys?
Student to talk to. That's always happened in the game, right? There's always been conversations all over the place that you could talk to kids. So I didn't know that there was anything meaningful at all, actually. I didn't get that impression. Maybe others did, but I didn't get that impression. So I didn't know that kind of like stopping or whatever and talking to the kids was going to be meaningful. But apparently,
bro,
I missed out on some
really
good dialogue. And
all you could have fucking done is just said, hey, you guys, I'm sorry I skipped the optional stuff. I didn't know it was there. I didn't know. So, yeah, that's there you go. But now we're having this, now it's a fucking plot line. Now it's a side story that Phil didn't talk to these fucking characters in the video game. And now it's a big deal because he makes it a big deal.
Comfortable conversation.
Nobody lost sleep over this.
Where people think that you're the headmaster or whatever. So, I apologize for that, but at the same time, you gotta understand if I didn't know it, how...
I apologize, but...
By the way, no one on the stream said anything.
Again, nobody told me.
Being honest here,
I apologize, but excuse. But I apologize.
For Hogwarts teams has dramatically dwindled.
That's what you do when you apologize. You make everybody else seem like they're guilty about something, and then you say, I'm sorry.
Actually, one of my lowest attendance streams right now.
And views.
Hogwarts and Like a Dragon Ishin, that actually is getting the least engagement.
You're playing both of them today, bozo. You fucking moron.
Of any other playthrough that I'm
both playing. Of them. Daystream Hogwarts, Nightstream Like a Dragon. Nice business.
So I get the feeling for the most part, a lot of people who even know the game aren't showing up to the streams anymore because it's taken a month and we're not done with it yet. You know? So I didn't know that. And I apologize, but at the same time, you gotta understand, I'm a variety streamer.
Again, I'm sorry, but immediately, he couldn't even let the I apologize rest. There's like, it's on a regular basis when he does that, when he says, I'm sorry. There's not even 3 to 5 seconds between him telling you that it was actually somebody else's fault in some way. I am sorry, but the video game.
I gotta keep things fresh. I gotta keep things going. Being honest, people are not watching this playthrough anymore. It's
views.
Like, I'm uploading videos. And they're not getting views. No one really is caring that much about it. The lines of attendees are here to chill with me, which I really appreciate.
Views.
But even then, I don't think that... Look, wow, I'm not even kidding you. I have episodes of this show, this game, from 2 to 3 days ago that don't have 300 views yet. No one cares about Hogwarts anymore. It's kind of old news. You know what I'm saying? And those who've been following the playthrough likely are hours and hours behind. How many are 40 hours in? So, that's what I mean, like...
I don't even know if people watch playthroughs anymore.
At the same time, you gotta understand, at some point...
Why would you watch Phil have a playthrough? Give me, like, an actual reason why you would watch him do a playthrough.
It has to end, you know? I do feel like maybe the game is too lengthy. that maybe they should have put less content into it or more meaningful content.
We still haven't got to the schedule segment, by the way, and to the Stuttering Craig interview segment, and to the shout outs, and to the Q&A.
It's dragged on.
And we're like 40 minutes in. I've been live for an hour and a half.
I gotta finish this.
I'm
still not done.
This is ass. No so cheeks, today, just ass.
Definitely finishing.
No pants, season. No diaper.
Definitely heading into the fourth season. That's what I'm talking.
No thong. Very fast. Just ass.
And then you kind of get to the end. That's when it takes a little while to finish the game. But
right. And he picked his ear again and wiped it off.
We're definitely heading into the fourth season. That's what I'm to understand. It's very fast moving. And then you kind of get to the end. That's when it takes a little while.
Get
to
a load of this. So today, wait, look. Okay. You pick the ear.
The third season. We're definitely heading into the fourth season. That's what I'm to understand. It's very fast moving.
Never mind. So, I was wrong this time.
One Piece Odyssey, Hogwarts Legacy, Oblivion. With so I'll do my best. Now tonight on the late stream, that had always kind of removed all the very important plot points and even added new story elements. I actually like that.
I don't give a fuck. I don't even know what he's talking about. I don't care. Oh, there was a hot.
That's as much as I'm gonna say. It doesn't feel the same.
Your wife?
I'm going to.
Oh, The Last of Us. He's talking about The Last of Us. It doesn't feel the same as the game. The TV show doesn't feel the same as the game. That's a hot, hot, melting take. Melting lava level opinion.
That's as much as I'm going to
say. It doesn't feel the same as the game.
Because if I go any further, it's going to spoil my review.
Spoilers. It doesn't feel the same as the game. This TV show doesn't feel like it's a video game. They should give me a controller in my hands.
Goes live on demand after my late stream for my review of the show. Okay, overall. All right. Some people are going to like it. Some people are going to be very upset with me. Too bad. It's my right to express my opinion. I'm going to do so on my channel.
Yeah, and it's people's right to express their opinions. And then you approve if it's correct or not. And then you let them post a comment. That's very nice, isn't it?
Okay. So, that's tonight. Now, tomorrow, it's going to be more long Fallen Dynasty on the...
I love those approved comments. It's all positive.
Again, hallelujah. It is Elder Scrolls 4 Oblivion.
Trash.
All right. Now, I get the feeling I know what's going on.
Podcast segment.
All right. I don't know because, you know, I'm not over there. I have been watching some of the podcasts.
Oh, there we go. Let's start from the beginning.
Because people have been asking me all week, Phil, when are you going to be on the Side Scrollers podcast? And I keep telling them, I'm not going to announce it. It's their show. It's on them to announce it, and they were telling me that they were going to announce it today on their show when the podcast appearance was going to be. They did not announce it today. They were going to announce it, and they said, oh, we'll talk about it tomorrow. All right? Now, I get the feeling I know what's going on. All right? I don't know because, you know, I'm not over there. I have been watching some of the podcasts, and I actually really like their show. I do. Admittedly, I'm an old-school fan of the Screw Attack stuff from the 2000s. All right, and so to have that vibe again back here in 2023, a group of people who all have different perspectives, and it's a good for fun variety show. I really like their show. Okay, just being honest, transparency. I watch it. Okay, but
he watched it ever since he knew he was gonna be on there. That's when he started watching it.
I know for a fact what's happened is since they announced that I was gonna be on the show, which I was afraid this was gonna happen. I did warn Craig about it. I said,
"Oh, should have kept it secret, Craig. You big nose freak.
That's exactly what
should have kept it secret
every day. You know they're trying to do their show, and they've probably got a ton of people in there. All right, that are not there for the show. They're literally there to crap on me daily."
Okay.
Whatever new thing, whatever new jab they can take at me, whatever new thing they can say on the show, which is stupid, has nothing to do with the content of their show, but it seems like this is what they've been doing.
Well, they're having you on, DSP. There's certain perks and downsides, also known as, I guess you can say, debuffs, with having DSP on your show. That's just what comes with it. And if you don't know who DSP is, those people, they're going to tell you. They're going to be very generous in how much info they share.
Constantly. I'm sure their stream chat is inundated. I'm sure the comments on their podcast are probably completely inundated with this filth. You know, what I used to go through.
Oh, me.
Like, literally, that's what my videos used to be until I turned on the ability to moderate the comments. Now, that stuff doesn't exist anymore because I have the ability to get rid of it.
And yeah, that's why there's whole channels made around that filth, right? There's whole channels. This is one right now. A million views, by the way. 1 mil. There you go. You created a monster much bigger than the one you tried to suppress. So congratulations, Phil. You won.
The productive comments beyond my content.
You fucking moron.
So, what I feel happens is every day they're just trying to do their own show, and every day they got these asshole idiots going in there. Oh, where's Phil? When's he gonna come out? Do you hate Phil? Well, fuck Phil. Can you imagine how tiring that is? They're just trying to do their own show, man. And they gotta put up with that shit, right? Seriously. And basically the way I see it is it's unfair to them. They didn't expect this. They weren't asking for it. It just kind of got thrown into this situation. I apologize publicly to them for any kind of bullshit. I wish I could control it or fix it. I can't, you know? I just can't. This is what I've lived with for a decade. This kind of nonsense everywhere I go. You know what I mean? It sucks. So to them, this is probably like the biggest momentous thing that's going to happen on the show, only because when it's done, they probably feel like they can finally breathe a sigh of relief and move on.
What?
I totally...
Bro, they don't have fucking ISIS on their ass. They have people leaving mean comments about DSP in their stream chat. Not even a member of their panel.
And of course,
bro, he's acting like there's fucking terrorist groups planting C4 all around the Screw Attack offices.
This was supposed to be... I was just supposed to be a
come on,
guest
dude.
On their show, a variety show. It wasn't supposed to be an interrogation of Phil, and now it is an interrogation.
Yeah, well, it should be. Okay. Should be. Because you're that guy. You're not normal. You're not normal. You're a freak in a cage. That's all you are. A freak in a cage. You put yourself in that cage, and you decided to be a freak show.
Say.
By acting like a freak.
Okay.
Don't be mad if people treat you like one.
Basically... they were, you know, they've been telling me, I'll be honest with you guys, I kind of knew when I was going to be on the show all along. I kind of knew. But I think that they wanted to do it at their own pace. They didn't want their show every day to be talking about it. But now I have to talk about it because I want you guys to know my schedule for the week. I mean, at this point, it's affecting me and my work, too. I need you guys to know what's going on this week.
It's affecting me.
All right. So, yes, I'm about to let the cat out of the bag. As long as nothing changes between now and then, and literally I don't think anything would change on my end. It would be on their end. So today I'm streaming. Tomorrow I'm streaming normally. Wednesday's my day off. Now they literally on the show this morning said, well, Friday we've got a full day of content. We're going to be playing Mario Kart and all this. I'm like, well, they kind of let the cat out of the bag too, because if you know my schedule and you know their schedule, let's see. I'm streaming today and tomorrow. I'm off on Wednesday, and they've got a day booked on Friday. I wonder what day I'll be appearing on the Science Scrollers podcast. Right?
It's Thursday, you guys. It's Thursday. There we go.
So, I think you can figure it out. All right? So, here's how it's going to work. All right? Their show airs much earlier than mine. Their show starts at 9 a.m. Pacific time. Okay, or 11 Central. I believe Craig lives in Central Time Zone, so that's why it's there. And their show usually runs about an hour to 2 hours. It depends on the subject matter or whatever. Okay, so my plans.
You gotta wake up at 8.
Okay, this Thursday, when normally I'd be coming back from break and I'd have a big podcast planned where I talk about Phil's day off and topics that happened on my day off and all of that. We're not doing that. Okay. I'm going to be on their podcast, 9 a.m. my time, which is way early for you guys. You guys usually don't jump on streams till like 11 a.m., but it's 9 a.m. So if you want to see me live on their show, you got to get up early, all right? You got to, and you got to head over there, 9 a.m. Pacific time.
Oh, the chat is going to be just boyfriends. It's going to be all the boyfriends in chat and all the dogs. There's going to be no dents in chat. Oh, no, I fucking refreshed. God damn it.
So even though I've addressed most... airs zone on my day off and all of that on the Side Scroller show. Side Scrollers is their YouTube channel. All right. And I'll be on there for as long as they want. I mean that. Like, I'm not limiting my time. Because originally I was asking, are you going to have like a normal show? Is it going to be like an hour long, an hour and a half long? And the way that we've been kind of going back and forth and discussing it is basically this. The interview is going to go however it goes, right? They may or may not ask more stuff about one way or the other way, and the topics are going to extrapolate. As I've told you guys, I really feel like, here's the thing. They're outsiders. They don't know anything about what's happened on the internet with me in the last 10 freaking years.
That's what he's hoping on. That's what he is counting on for the life of him.
No idea.
That's why he feels so comfortable. He's very, like I said yesterday on That Being Said, he feels very comfortable going into this. He feels very confident because he knows that stuttering fucking Craig doesn't give a rat's ass about him. He didn't even know he was alive up until like 2 weeks ago. And the other dudes on the panel and that lady, they probably don't give half a shit if this dude is alive or in a plastic bag in the ocean somewhere.
Bombarded for two straight weeks with so much nonsense from my detractors, they probably don't know how to make heads or tails of any of it. They wouldn't probably don't even know where to start to ask questions, right? So who knows where the discussion's going to go. I really feel this. This is the truth. I really feel if someone were to actually do a full-fledged interview and address every question, it would take a day. Because that's how much shit has been made up about me on the internet. And I want to emphasize that. Made up about me. Because there are a lot of things that are truthful. Laughing my ass off. I've already addressed in things, like when I reacted to my Down the Rabbit Hole video last year, and or with the answers that I've given over time here on my own shows and content. The problem is, number one, all that has never been put into one focal point. It's kind of been spread out. You got the Down the Rabbit Hole react. You've got various podcasts and videos here or there. It's never really been one. Just watch this if you want your answers or if you want to hear Phil's answers.
Dude, right? This is going to...
Number two.
This is not going to go well for him. I still think it's going to be very disappointing, but it's going to have nowhere near the positive effect that he thinks it will. Because for the next 10 years, he's going to be here and be like, remember this podcast they did in 2023? You can just go there and look it up. I said everything, and he asked me questions, and then I said the answers to the best of my ability and according to the legal guidance that I was given. So there they are. Go click on him. Go.
The answers that I've given have been...
And also, fucking Craig's not going to get anything out of this because it's going to be some stupid show that is going to be different from everything else they do. It's like if we have Alex Jones on That Being Said, it's going to get like 500,000 fucking views, but none of those people are going to give a shit about Darkside fucking Phil, so none of them are going to stick around.
Easily just summarily dismissed by my detractors anyway. So even though I've addressed most of the nonsense that they've said about me, they don't care. They refuse to accept my answers as valid. So in that case, it doesn't really matter.
Are they valid though? Are they backed by proof? Like actual tangible proof that you can show?
They've been answered.
You know what proof means? What is proof actually?
Why do you want the question answered or asked again? It doesn't even make sense. Every question they've thrown at me, I've answered.
There we go. Evidence or argument establishing a fact or the truth of a statement.
It seems the interview will be a nothing burger.
Yes, it's going to be a delicious nothing
burger. One. Every single one. Right? But they just
big ups,
like
Nozaku boy.
You see? So I don't know what's going to happen. You would think their show at the longest podcast they've ever done is 2 hours. So you would think they're going to do a 2-hour show where it's just going to be constant questions, me answering, and likely by the end of the show, they're not even going to get through half the stuff. You know what I'm saying? Like, I really feel that.
Yes.
I really feel like it's going to be, they're hearing all these answers.
He's going to give them a 20-minute response to literally everything. And it's just going to be like overwhelming for a simple Craig type person to take in all that bullshit. Considering they haven't like actually, as ridiculous as it might sound, studied this fucking guy. Because this guy, like Gundam says in one of his videos, you got to study this dude like it's the Quran. You gotta actually like do your fucking research and watch his videos, cause he's very easily can hook you on some fake ass bullshit story that he convinced himself that is true, cause he's a master at gaslighting himself, and he's only as good as gaslighting himself and a couple of other susceptible den heads,
first time
who can be gaslit by a plastic bag,
and they're like, oh, right, and they're basically gonna be like. So this is they're gonna have more questions. They're gonna be follow-ups. It's not just like, here's a question, here's your answer, on to the next question. I don't even think it's gonna be, here's a question, here's your answer, oh, here's a follow-up, okay, here's my follow-up, let's discuss this in detail and go back and forth till you're satisfied, right? But it feels like that's gonna take so long, you know what I'm saying? So I don't think we're gonna get through nearly enough. And what's gonna end up happening is it's gonna be an interrogation. I know it is. At the end of the show,
are you going to burp?
I'm likely going to feel like, you know, like I was just fucking in an interrogation room with a bunch of detectives with a fucking spotlight on me, which wasn't the point of me appearing on their show, but that apparently
he's going to be absolved at the end of the show.
Okay. Okay.
It's gonna be he's free. It's like the end of Shawshank Redemption. He comes out the shit pipe and then he stands in the rain and he has done it. That's it. He wins.
Seems like that's what has to happen.
He's destroyed the trolls. And he's gonna come on stream and he's gonna be mega smug about it. He's gonna be the smuggest Phil you've ever seen.
Who are my viewers who are here on my content every day to watch me live, and you've heard these answers before. I mean it when I say this. If you watch me on the Side Scrollers podcast on Thursday, you're not going to hear or see pretty much anything new. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's going to be the answers you've heard, which is why you're still here every day to hang out with me. You've heard the answers. You're satisfied with the answers, right? And you move on. But these people, my detractors, don't. They can't. They're obsessive. So they don't get the answer they want, which is they want the answer that's going to somehow expose me for horrid wrongdoings and ruin it. It's not going to happen because that's not truthful. Do you see? So you're never going to get that. And that's what they're looking for. Like, seriously, that's what they're looking for. And it's not going to happen. So I don't know what they're expecting. By bombarding the Side Scrollers crew with all these questions about me, they're not going to get giant revelations and shit like that.
How many tractors are there per fan, you think?
Bro, fan is somebody who stands up for you. They're nobody who stands up for DSP. People like fucking like Tipster and Review Tech USA need to stand up for people like Phil. Like, because that's what actually happens. He doesn't have anybody to stand up for him. More often than not, is other detractors that stand up for him if they want to call somebody out and call him like with fucking Pastor Miller, for example. Because that's what fans do. They defend you, right? Because back in the day, I remember on DSP Cult Leader, if you go to that channel, there are so many comments from actual DSP fans. And there's none of them now. Not on Twitter, not on YouTube, not on fucking Reddit, not even on Kiwi Farms. A place where you could be completely anonymous.
I've essentially told you guys as much as I can without putting my family and myself and my business at risk.
Putting his business at risk. What does that even mean?
A little bit of additional
flip. What does that mean, putting my business at risk? Putting my ability to play video games for the internet at risk? What does this mean? It almost sounds like it's a gimmick statement just to say it, and you don't actually mean it, because it means nothing.
Out of a little bit here and there.
Putting my family at risk. How can people already hurt his family? And they couldn't until now. They have literally all of his personal info. They got his gate codes to his gated community. They got all the info necessary to hurt him if they wanted to. Are you fucking kidding me? They're gonna hurt my family.
My God, jaw-dropping revelations on this show. It's just not gonna happen.
It's not gonna happen. I agree with that.
So, that's what I mean. Like, I don't understand where these people are coming from with the level of harassment and stuff, but that's how they are. They're just obsessed with this nonsense.
What is this nonsense? You?
Can I tell you how long I will be on the Side Scrollers podcast this week? No. I have
no. It doesn't matter.
It'll be the record longest show they've ever done, a fucking marathon.
A marathon. Right?
It could be. I have no idea. I'm not limited.
At some point, bro, at some point it's going to get super cringe. And it's going to get uncomfortable for everybody, so they want to let you go. Or talk about video games. They're going to talk about video games for like 10 minutes. It's going to be like, oh, Phil, yeah, we know you were good at Street Fighter. Do you like Street Fighter? Yes, I like Street Fighter. Okay, Phil, thanks for stopping by. This was the Side Scrollers podcast. Smash the like button and the subscribe button. Follow us on Twitter. That's going to be it.
To saying, oh, I'm only going to be on that show for this amount of time, and then I'm cutting it off. No, I'm not going to do that. All right? I'm going to give those guys respect. Because those guys respected me. They offered to have me on their show for fun. They've
for
had
fun.
Harassment. Completely unfair.
They're acting like they got like pipe bombs mailed to them in the mail, bro.
Coming on their streams,
give me no fucking break.
Not about me. You know? I feel awful, but again, it's not something that I can control because this
he doesn't feel awful.
The realm of anything that I have anything to do with or control. As you guys know, and I said this before, I'll say it again, I stay in my lane. I sit here on my streams, I just pay attention to me and myself and my own content. That's it. I have no idea. I've even told you guys, I have
really?
No idea what they've been talking about for the past couple of months. I don't pay attention to it. I'm sure they've made up more stuff. There's been more drama videos. I don't watch any of them. I pay no attention to
them. Yeah, you do, Phil. Yeah, you do. You say immediately when he has an unrecorded segment, you know what he says?
I know the trolls are going to say that this is an unrecorded segment because I'm going to be begging, but that's not true. I put it out there on the internet, right?
He knows exactly what the trolls are saying at every living waking moment. And that's why he tries to do the opposite. Just not because it's the right thing to do, because the trolls are gonna say something, and he wants to get a one-up on the trolls. That's why this interview is happening, by the way, because the trolls said immediately as Craig was bombarded with info about DSP, the trolls said it wouldn't happen. And he, because he's a stubborn son of a bitch, wanted to make it happen, to get a one-up on the trolls. And now the trolls are gonna get all the fun! We get stuff to talk about for the last 2 weeks to the point where I'm fucking sick and tired of it. And we're going to be getting more lore from that video and onwards for fucking weeks. So thank you, Phil. The trolls are the target demographic for that video, for that interview. They're the only ones who are going to get anything. And they're the only ones who are going to have fun with it.
I'm just here putting out the content.
Because you know everybody's gonna make their own reaction to it. You're gonna see that interview 15,000 times. It's gonna be Ann Lead, it's gonna be Ludwig, it's gonna be Tevin. GTG is gonna make his probably like 6 months from now. I'm gonna be watching that shit. Shinko's gonna watch it. Chill Murray's gonna watch it. He's gonna be super high when he does it. We're gonna talk about it on That Being Said. Poems Mystery is gonna talk about it on Twitter. Kiwi Farm is gonna have 40 pages about it the first day. You know how this is gonna go. We're the only ones who're gonna have some fun out of it. And DSP is gonna have 2 hours of patting himself on the back of how amazing he was on that podcast, on his own podcast. And then we go business as usual, back to crying.
That I enjoy making, that you guys like and support, that's all I care about. So let them do what they wanna do, right? And be stupid, but I'm not gonna be, you know, talking about their crap or anything at all in my content. So, you know, being in my own lane and paying attention to my own shit, I wish I could control what they do. I can't. So, you know, the moment that these guys on Side Scrollers mentioned I was going to be on the show, it's like 2 weeks of bullshit. I'm sure I'm telling you, these guys are going to breathe the biggest sigh of relief when this interview's done. They're going to be like, thank God, it's over.
Oh, no.
Back to normal business.
Oh, no. You got to be crazy if you think that's going to happen. They got to lock up that comment section. If they do a shit job, they're going to have to lock up the comments. Even if they do a remotely decent job, most people still not going to be happy. Because, like, the expectations, since they've been hyping this shit up for, like, what, two and a half weeks? Expectations are going to be very high from certain detractors. Not me, but I can see a lot of people out there who expect this to be something pretty big. And it's probably not going to be, and they're going to be disappointed, and they're going to be pissed off.
Not to worry about.
And yes, probably no live chat as well. It's going to be severely limited. It's going to be members only, sub only, like 48, 65,000 hours.
These people coming by every day talking about Darkseid Phil, right? And I hear that. I you know what? When it's done, I'm gonna breathe a sigh of relief too, because I feel bad for them. I do. I feel like shit because I don't want other people to have negative impact on their lives because of me. I didn't really do anything, you know. It's not like I said something bad. I caused this situation. This is 100% on my detractors.
I did nothing wrong. That's why I have 15 years of lore about me that people actually study. People watch documentaries on this and take notes and make large videos because I did nothing wrong. I did everything correct. Oh, I did nothing wrong.
Now.
I did nothing wrong. Why are these people so obsessed with me? I did nothing wrong. Ever.
After the show ends, which we don't know how long the show is going to be. All right. Then once the show. What's up, Jade? Good to see you. Once the show is done and I say goodbye to those guys, then I'm going to head over here to my channel, DSP Gaming. We're going to turn on the stream, and we're going to do a decompression stream. What does that mean? It means I'm sure that after having been bombarded...
What does that mean? He's going to be smooching on his own cock. That's what it's going to mean.
Bombarded by questions. Crazy amounts of questions.
He's going to sit there and tell himself how well it went. That's what it's going to be. He's going to sit there, and he's going to be like, oh, you guys, this was... You know, I told you this is what it's going to be. This is what it's going to be. I answered to the best of my abilities. I told you everything factually, truthfully, honestly, transparently, meaningfully. And, you know, I think they liked me. And, you know, we might have another podcast together.
Okay. I'm going to need to relax.
Going to need to relax.
Compress from the nonsense. Okay?
He didn't need to relax after his bankruptcy hearing.
Right? I need to... Okay.
Oh, that shit was classic. I wish I could relive that again, man. And that's something that I love about this niche internet shit that is like, if I told somebody, like, for example, I tell my girlfriend about, you know, this dude I'm talking about on the internet, his bankruptcy hearing came out and they streamed it on the internet and I fucking watched it and I laughed my ass off. And she's going to just be looking at me like, look, what?
I just have a little bit of chill time here on a stream. And I'm sure some people are going to say, oh, it went this way, it went that way. Personally, like I said, no, I don't think that it's going to be good or bad or whatever. I think it's just going to be, it happened and we get it done with and we kind of move on back to normalcy. Okay. And when will that start? I have no idea. Right. Like, literally, I have no clue. I don't know how long the show is going to be. I don't know when the show is going to end. So I can't guarantee you a starting time over here.
Yeah. Okay. We got it. He said this already like 4 times.
Now, we're all good and we can just move on. You want to see me do something else? Maybe we could. Maybe we could jump into something else or whatever. I don't know.
You can jump into a pit of vipers. Can we do that?
You know, normally, like I said, their show starts 9 a.m. my time and it would end roughly.
Can we jump into a pit of used heroin needles like in Saw?
The way I see it, let's say.
He's a movie buff, right?
Let's say the show.
Let's do it. Come on.
Which it might. It might not. I don't know what they're doing. They basically told me if you could not limit your time, they'd appreciate that. And I hear that. Like, you know, I don't want to limit their time. I want them to be able to ask whatever they want to ask. All right, I'm hoping it's not going to be a 5-hour interrogation-a-thon. I really do.
Interrogation-a-thon.
Once they're done, and then we'll start up over here whenever we get a chance, and that'll be that. And then after that, we'll determine, do we just want to talk for the rest of the day?
Just
a kind of a chill stream.
What is a chill stream?
My day off, I will have things to talk about, like Phil's day off and stuff like that, right?
Phil's day off hasn't been interesting since, like, I don't know, weeks ago.
Maybe we just want to talk about the interview. I don't know.
What are we going to talk about the interview that you didn't talk about during the interview?
Oh, it's going to go, right?
It's not a job interview. It's people asking you about your personal life and where your money goes. You still want to talk about that? Even though you yourself admitted you've talked about this over and over and over again, we're going to talk about it some more.
So,
hey guys, did you guys like it when they asked me about WWE champions and I told them that it didn't happen and it would put my family at risk? Did you guys like it? Then he just sits there looking at chat. Yes, yes. Oh, there we have a fucking idiot. Yes, yes. Oh, we have another fucking idiot who says $5,000 business expenses. I told you it didn't fucking happen.
No, see, Alexander, I'm not going to do that. He's like, you could just leave if it takes too long. The only way I would leave.
He could just leave. Just disconnect the call. Act like his internet is going down.
Basically, I'm feeling like they're completely 1,000,000% attacking me.
Oh, there we go. If they're distractors.
A fair shake, which I don't think they're going to do. That's number one. Or
he's setting it up.
Literally, the show is going past.
I'm not going to leave you guys. Come on.
No, I'm not going to be going on their show at 9 a.m. and continuing past 4 p.m. That's not happening.
They're not going to do that.
That's insane. Now, you know,
he's never worked that long of a day in his life. Come on. He's not doing it for a podcast where they're going to ask him questions about his money.
Do my own stream that long. I'm not doing their stream that long either. All right. I don't think that's going to happen either. Okay. So, you know, that's what's happening. So, again?
What's
curious is that I haven't told you guys yet what day it is. Do you know what
it's on Thursday.
I already basically...
Yes.
...all the other information.
It's Thursday.
Let's see. All right, everyone, based on what I just told you, what day am I appearing on their podcast?
Thursday. And I saw the dance in his chat was saying a bunch of different days, like the... Yeah, it's Saturday, Thursday, LOL, Saturday, Friday, Wednesday. They don't give a fuck, dude.
How do you guys not...
DSP, they don't care about you as much as you think, man. They actually don't. And he thinks, like, legitimately, he thinks they have some sort of a connection, some sort of a relationship. Bro, these people show up to watch you play fucking video games, and they put your stupid podcast in the background. Just like they do to mine. I just know that. I know that. Hello, person who is at work right now listening to this or washing dishes. This is exactly what I mean this to be. It's not something profoundly meaningful or important to society. And we don't have a very deep personal connection. Jesus fucking Christ, DSP. You're not that important to those people.
How do you not know?
How do you not know?
Okay. Let's try it again. Today I'm streaming all day. Tomorrow I'm streaming all day. Wednesday is my day off. Friday, they announced today.
He expects them to care so much about his personal life, but in only good ways. Only care about me in good ways. Don't care about me in bad ways, internet.
Oh, they're busy all day because they're doing a special event playing Mario Kart. What day do you think I'm appearing on the Side Scrollers podcast?
That's a difficult question for your fans, Phil. They can't even figure out which hand they want to eat with. They're so stupid. Look, he's mocking him now. And he has this... Oh, now I can see clearly. He has this, like, one line of hair on his left side that used to be on the other side last week, but now it's on the other side. It's so weird. He's balding in, like, the most embarrassing, bizarre ways. It's not even like a wrestler who is past his prime and just has to shave it off, and then immediately, eventually, they do, and they don't look as bad. It's just, like, the sad type of balding. Where you just kind of have to embrace it. Anyways, though, yeah, look at this. This is not hot.
God, I swear people are just trolling me.
People are just trolling. No, they're that stupid for real. They're stupid or they don't care about you.
Sure, I know you.
You gotta embrace it, dude. You're not that important to those people's lives. You're a dude on the internet who makes YouTube videos. Even not for the trolls. If he fucking went away, there's a million billion lolcows.
I know you guys are messing with me. Some of you have said it. Some people are purposefully saying things like, "You're playing Mario Kart?" Oh my god. Anyway.
He also has the worst fingers.
At least you guys figured it out. Without me outright.
And he picked his ear, looked at it. Fantastic.
Okay. They're supposed to officially announce it on their show tomorrow, but I feel like I had to talk about this because how else would you not know? Because normally I would tell you exactly what I'm doing every day. How would you not know what I'm not doing on a certain day? Because I'm not mentioning it. It's kind of weird, no?
Hey, what's up, DeadXO? How's it going, man?
So, yeah.
You missed a pretty hot pre-stream so far.
It's going to be a very...
Not very, but, like, I guess. Maybe I'm just drinking too much.
I'm not even starting my content at its normal time. I'm going to be on their show and go as long as it needs to go. And then, you know, I'll be here afterward. And we'll see how it goes. Now,
all right, we get it.
If the show goes, let's say the show's normal length and it's just 2 hours. If their show is 2 hours long and then I could start up my stream, say, by like 11:30-ish, then we could still have a normal day, right? We could do the Level 1 podcast. I assume the podcast will go much longer than usual as we kind of decompress, but then we'll probably play Hogwarts. We'll probably do some Hogwarts. It probably won't be a full length 3 hour stream, but we'll probably do some Hogwarts, all right? But it might not happen either. It might just be that I do the interview, I come over here way late, and then we just chill for an hour or two and we talk, okay?
What am I drinking? I'm just drinking a casual beer today. I'm feeling a beer to celebrate the 1 million views of the channel. 1 million channel views. Thanks, everybody. I appreciate this. To 1 million more.
Stream on.
Look at how many upgrades. Go watch my first stream and go watch this one now. Look at how upgraded it is. 1 million views ago. That's incredible.
Thursday, no matter what.
And it's all your fault, by the way. All of you sending me money that I put back in my business. That's all of you. Bought the laptop, the camera, this microphone here, this headset here. All of this. With charitable, meaningful contributions. Maybe this beer as well.
We'll be like a Dragonician. That'll be normal. And then Friday... excuse me.
Wow.
Sorry, I should have turned around.
Wow.
That's really gross.
That was really gross. That's correct.
Friday... I'll either be playing Hogwarts if I didn't play it on Thursday, or it's going to be more Wolong, and that's going to be paired with Oblivion. And then Saturday is my weekly stream of DSP versus the Internet, the React show that I do on DSP React. So that's the main stream on Saturday. And then we play it by ear and we go from there, okay? That's the rough schedule. Now, special things coming up later this month. On the 24th...
Here's to the next million.
Yeah, there we go. Big ups. I'm going to take a sip again because it's just beer. It's not gin. It's not gin.
Resident Evil 4 remake. I'll be playing that all day long.
Oh, and this is boring now. So why does he do it? Like, why does he burp and stuff? There is one theory that I guess it is kind of passive aggressive because he knows. He knows people hate him doing it. He knows people hate watching it. He knows people hate hearing it, but his fans actually don't care, right? So, like, just like when he snorts and stuff, they don't complain about it. So there you go. He does it to annoy the trolls, basically. He does so many things intentionally to piss off the trolls.
This is a big butt. I cannot lie.
We got a big butt.
The show originally was scheduled for Thursday the 30th. It looks like it may actually have to be Friday the 31st. The reason being, it looks like my day off that week may be pushed
a day. We don't give a fuck, dude. Go fuck off. What show is he even talking about? Reactathon?
Okay. Free from June the King. Versus the
Internet. Oh, June the King watching Wings of Redemption. Big up Spyro Goon for the membership, dude. Thank you. And yeah, I see some people in chat mention my leaks video. This is actually the video that it's one of those where it's like, is the one that I hate the most because it was super lazy and it was just like super like on the go. But I knew it was going to help me out a lot to get some eyes on the channel. So I had to do it. But I hate it. I hated doing it. I wish I put some more effort into it.
For Thursday the 30th, it looks like it may actually have to be Friday the 31st. The reason being, it looks like my day off that week may be pushed a day. Normally my day off is on a Wednesday, but it looks like my day off may actually end up being a Thursday that week. And if that does end up being the case, then that means that Ask the King has to be Friday rather than Thursday.
Oh, and we're doing Ask the King again.
So just for full transparency.
So for him, the gimmick between Ask the King and the daily Q&A is because during Ask the King, he actually gets to answer in detail. So he gets to have a prepared, long, tedious, annoying, obnoxious, long-winded answer to a very simple question.
My birthday event, which is going to happen on
let's talk about a birthday
April 6th. We're going to talk about what you guys want to see. So far we talked about doing a tier maker deal where I do several on my stream where we can rank things like horror movies, horror games, fast food, and stuff.
Speaking
like that.
Of which, we did a very cool one with Darkseid of Phil on Christmas,
you know, stuff like that. So
what's it called?
We need more ideas for that. What else you'd like to see during my birthday day? Okay, I think one thing we're going to do, thanks to the very big generosity of the Dutch brothers, I think one thing we're going to do...
Oh, we're going to drink gin. Like we did during is this one. And we did a DSP 2022 drama tier list, and it was hot as hell. It was so good. It's one of my favorite podcasts we've ever done. And my control key is stuck.
Some shots of that during the stream for my
fuck me.
Okay?
Okay.
So there you go. All right. That's what I had to cover. All right? So that's a lot. It's a lot to absorb. So let's recap. Today, Hogwarts Legacy, Like a Dragon Ishin, and my finale review
of
Last of Us Episode 9 and the whole season over on DSP Reacts later.
Who are the Dutch brothers? Is fanboys that send him stuff.
Off on Wednesday.
They send an actual self-professed alcoholic. They send him gin because he told them he likes it, and they sent him gin.
And then Thursday, yes, is the big day. The interview is taking place on Thursday in the morning, 9 a.m. Pacific time over on the Side Scrollers channel. I don't know how long it's going to go. After that interview eventually ends, I'm going to come back over here and start up my stream. If it's time permitting, we'll do our usual podcast and gameplay. If not, if we go long over there, then we'll just do like a decompression stream. That'll be fine. And then Thursday night will be Like a Dragon Ishin. And Friday's up.
Yeah, they actually sent him gin. But I don't think the Dutch brothers are Dutch. I think that's just how they're called. I think they might be American.
Is that a good enough summary? I hope that covered a lot. And there's a lot of stuff to talk about. Okay. And again, I hope the schedule adheres. I hope that nothing changes.
Because the Dutch Brothers is also like a coffee company that specializes in iced coffee.
You know, stays there.
You know?
It wouldn't be on my choice.
You know?
At all.
You know?
I'm full speed ahead on everything right now. Okay? Cool. Okay. Let's do shoutouts.
We start shoutouts. Code Man.
123434 who has...
Yeah!
Oh, by the way, I forgot to do something. Holy moly. I forgot our daily members call. Remember, this is something...
Oh, no. Go fuck off.
But I would be interested in that, yes. Obviously, I would like to rent the movie, but it looks like you can't rent it. It would be amazing. The way you can watch the movie is to watch that movie. First, your thoughts on Wolong. I remember when you played Sekiro, you constantly complained that it was terrible.
This is fucking bait, man. You want him to talk about Wolong again? He had like a 10-minute long fucking segment today, you asshole.
Frustrated when you play these games and they get better for you, or they're better than you give them credit.
Oh, fuck off.
No, here's the deal. I don't think Sekiro is as good as Souls. I agree with that statement. I stand by it. I think Dark Souls is better because Sekiro is a one-trick pony.
Okay, we get it. Yeah, we get it.
People right now really want me to play Elden Ring again. It's been about a year. There's been enough time passing since my 140-plus-hour playthrough. And they want the game back. They're like, bring it back now. Let's do a new game plus run. Let's do things differently, right? No one's saying play Sekiro again. I think that stands the testament of time right there. Like, that's why. It's just a one-trick pony game. It's not a bad game, but it definitely is a basic game compared to other things FromSoft has pumped out there. Okay? That's my criticism. Excuse me.
Wow. You're not excused. That's not how excuse me works. That's like John Rambo said. Apologizing isn't just words. It means I will not do this thing again. If you apologize and keep doing the thing, then you're not actually sorry.
Sent me a different currency tip. Hold on a second. Snowcarl, how did you manage this? Snowcarl originally sent me the dollar tip. Then he sent me a different currency tip.
Huh?
How did you even manage to do that? I didn't even know you could do that. I don't even know how much this is. Like, I wish I could say, oh, this is a dollar or this is two. It's another currency.
Hey, that's a good question, and I'm going to stop the stream for now. How is it all going to end? Alcohol poisoning, murdered by a dent, jail time, or trampled by his horse? I think it's going to be a very slow and painful death for the channel. It's going to be kicking and screaming. Eventually, he's going to lose the house because you can't keep that house. He's barely holding on right now. He's going to move back to Connecticut, and that's going to be the big L. That's going to be the biggest L he will ever take, is moving back to Connecticut. Or maybe he's going to outlive his parents. Maybe they have a bunch of savings they need to leave for him, but I'm not very confident in that.
He says it was a mistake. I have to try to look at this and see how much it even is.
In any case, he's going to be miserable as fuck trying to convince himself that he's happy every day of his life. And that's going to be the DSP life. It's going to be him sitting on screen trying to tell you that he's happy. And like a generation of detractors from now who like do next level kind of shit is going to be having so much fun with that type of content. I don't think I'm going to be around.
If I have to update the leaderboard or not. Because I don't even know. I literally don't even know. Hold on.
I think that is a good point, Mavis. I think a lot of us are here to see what's going to happen. Because I like to be an observer myself. I like to watch on the freak show. I like to comment on it. I don't get involved directly in it. I make things about it that are fun to me to make. And I would like to see how it's going to end, but at some point, if I get burned out or I just don't care enough, I'm not going to keep up with it. But I know he's still going to be here.
Benefit of the doubt. He says, I got most of my taxes done. No, he says, I just got done with my taxes. He says, you're getting a bunch back. Are you one of the people who think you should allow yourself to spend?
Oh, there we go. That's bait.
Returns on whatever you want. If what should I use it for?
Spending tax returns.
He says he okay, let me try this again.
Dude, you know what he's talking about. You know.
Are you one of the people who think you should allow yourself to spend returns on whatever you want? If so, what should I? Oh, I totally misread it. What he's saying is, do I believe that if you were to get a refund, a tax refund?
Yes.
Okay. That you should be able to kind of consider that like funny money.
Funny money. This
is bonus money.
Funny money. Spend it on whatever you this want. Money got a great sense of humor.
Basically, that's
hilarious.
How
it's telling me dick jokes and fart jokes. I love it. This money is great.
Treat it. You know, back when I had 9-to-5 jobs and my tax returns were super easy. It was, oh, here's your W-2. Plug in the numbers. Boom. Auto-calculated. Send it to the government. Government sends you a refund later. Beautiful. Right? And they'd be like, oh, look at this money I just got back. Now what do I want to do with it? And a lot of the times, that money would go towards hobbies and stuff. Like, for example, when I used to play Street Fighter, I would travel.
Hobbies and stuff.
I got as a tax return, that would pay for my trip.
He would also get business loans and max out credit cards to do exactly that thing. Hobbies and stuff. This shit made him fucking broke for life, dude. Hobbies and stuff. You might as well have been doing crack behind a fucking dumpster somewhere.
Right? Or maybe buy a new joystick to play in tournaments, or you know what I'm saying, like stuff like that. Travel expenses, you know, gaming expenses, stuff like that. The moment that I became independent and started my own business and ran it as such, that all ended. Really, like whenever you run your own business, it doesn't matter. It literally doesn't matter how much you think you know you need to pay or whatever. I don't think there may have been, I'm serious about this. There may have been 1 year when I overpaid on my taxes since I owned my own business, and it was like the first year, the very first year, I overpaid. And then they said, oh, you have a refund. How would you like to apply it? And I'm almost positive I said, just apply it to the next year. That way it reduces what I owe for the next year. It, why get the money back just so that, just for, I know I have to pay more money next year for taxes regardless. Just roll it into the next year. That's what I did. And then most other years, like I said, it's always you pay your estimate. And then you do your taxes at the end. They're like, well, technically you were under by this amount, you know. So, and then you have to pay it off. Whether you have the money, you pay it in a lump sum, or you put it into a payment plan, or whatever you end up doing. You know, and that's just what's always happened to me since I own my own business. So over a decade now, you know, that's the deal. So, yeah, when I had a simple 9-to-5 job, it was super easy. I always got a refund, and it was always like, ooh, bonus. You know, what do I do with this now? But now I don't get that anymore. No, you know, most people who own their own business never get that. Okay. Okay. So I counted that as a dollar tip, even though technically I think it was like 94 cents. I'll give Snowcrawl the benefit of the doubt.
He usually rounds them down.
Oh, wait, never mind. Bloomkit did a second super chat. Bloomkit says, you can cancel Showtime immediately when you sign up. You still get the month free. There's some good stuff on there as well. See, here's the thing. If I end up doing that, then I want to be sure I'm getting value out of it. Right now, I already have HBO Max.
What do you mean value out of something that is free? You get it for free. You can use it whenever you want, and then you cancel it, and you get the thing for free. We need to make sure we get value out of something that is free. Aren't you getting a little bit too greedy?
I already have, you know, Amazon Prime's not going to go anywhere. But HBO Max, I'm kind of paying month to month. I just saw the final episode of The Last of Us, and I'm almost positive it's about to auto-renew. So once HBO Max auto-renews, then I've got it for another month.
Cancel it.
I might cancel it after that.
Okay, cancel it now.
If there's particular services where you guys feel there's something you really want to see me watch, then maybe I would use that service for that 1 month.
Oh my God.
Like, I might do that. I might sign up for 1 month.
Bro, this dude gets hundreds of fucking thousands of dollars, man. And now we penny pinching for fucking streaming services. Are you serious? We actually serious? He's spending hundreds of dollars a month on takeout food. Fucking takeaway DoorDash fucking bullshit. Six figures a year. Now we having segments talking about fucking HBO Max that we can't pay it. Shit is like, what, $10, $15 per month? Jesus Christ.
Do it for that month. Cancel, right? And then, and you know what I'm saying?
Fuck me. Big ups, Tyler. Tyler, for the sub.
I mean, right now, I'd be interested in watching the Justice League Snyder Cut. I would like to...
Snyder Cut. I would like. Please don't watch the Snyder Cut.
And the Peacemaker series. Like, that stuff's interesting to me right now. But eventually that's...
I mean, look, I understand him trying to squeeze the dance because he makes the most money during the pre-stream. And right now, he's at $2 and one of them is from Snowcarl. And then, so I guess I can see why he resorts to desperate tactics, because he knows he can't fund this lifestyle for the next, I don't know what, how long he's going to live, like 30 years, if he's going to make it to 70. It's probably like a late 60s type of a casket that we're looking for him. But he can't make it, man. He's already barely making ends meet. So we got to do anything possible. Streaming services cost too much. Then it's going to be, I don't know, lights cost too much. You guys, I got to turn off the LED lights. They're too expensive. I saw the electricity bill last month. It was so big. I cannot believe this.
And what do I want to watch? Well, maybe I want to watch stuff from other services, in which case...
Because it is pretty clear at this point. He wants to stream until he is in the grave. He's going to stream until he's in a casket and gets buried, and that casket is gonna get paid by Dance, because there's nobody else can pay it. And when he dies, Kat is off to whatever she decides to do.
Oh, and I'll go get another one, and I might actually rotate them. I might rotate the services so that I have content to watch and react to for you guys, okay? So there you go. But I don't want to have them all. So if I, for example, if I'm going to get the Showtime deal, I might join Showtime when I'm ready to watch a bunch of
Bro is acting like he's LeBron James. Oh, you know what? I might join the Miami Heat. But then again, you know, I might join the LA Lakers because, you know, it's like the Lakers. They got a better contract. He's acting like he's a free agent, dude. And he's talking about what kind of streaming service he's going to get, man. The Showtime deal. He's going to the Lake Show.
And I watch
That's what's up.
Everywhere all at once. Maybe I watch
he's going to play with Anthony Davis. He's going to be doing the, I don't know what, passing him the water.
Three other movies on there. I review them all within a month, and then I get rid of Showtime and move on to another service. Do you see?
We move on. We're going to leech off of everything for free.
What happens here?
What a fucking pathetic leech.
Yes, Snow Carl, I got your 6 cents. Thanks. You didn't have to do that.
Did he send him 6 cents? Snow Carl sent him extra 6 cents.
Because it had a lot of shows.
Oh, that's so good.
I watched things like Stranger Things. I watched the Haunting of
Hill House.
Hill House, whatever that
was. Was it Bly Manor?
So
Hill House?
Those, and I really liked them. But then, after a while, I had Netflix for over a year. I watched 2 seasons of Stranger Things or whatever.
Okay.
There was like nothing to watch on there. Like, I was trying to watch other movies and shows, and I was like, none of these are very good. I just didn't like most of them. So I ended up just canceling it.
Did he watch Squid Games? Oh no, because it has a bunch of Asian people in it.
Just a single thing, besides maybe The Witcher show.
It actually doesn't even have a single white person in it, which is super racist if you ask me. It's very exclusive.
That people were talking about for like 2 seasons, and now it seems like no one cares about it anymore because, what's his name? The head actor, Henry Cavill, is leaving. So now it seems like that show is dead in the water. So it seems like there's really no reason.
I think now is the time to say that The Witcher show, besides Henry Cavill, was not that good. It was not very good. It was like a, I hate giving number ratings, but I will in this case. It was like a 6.5. Just because of Henry Cavill. The dude was, you could see he was dedicated. He loved playing that role. He did it great. It was fun to watch him on screen. Everybody else was ass. The CGI was ass. The costumes were bad. The acting was corny. The writing was bad. The storytelling was bad. There you go. That's just my opinion.
Netflix right now, right? So. Okay. So, guys, just a couple more minutes here, and then we're going to end the show and take a quick break.
Oh, yeah. There are good Netflix shows.
Yes, I did watch BoJack Horseman. I never saw the final season. I did watch a lot of BoJack Horseman. I found it a fun, fascinating, but ultimately depressing show.
No, it's depressing. Really?
Red Gamer says, once Stranger Things final season comes out, I'm sure people would ask me to review it. Maybe. You know, I didn't see the last season. I missed it. I saw seasons 1, 2, and 3. The last one I saw
was... Oh, yeah. BoJack Horseman reminded him of Cat. That's why it was so depressing. Oh, my God. This dude could steal my wife. He looks just like her. They're soulmates.
Season where they all work at the mall or whatever. Like, that's the last season I saw. I did not see the season after that.
Hey, what?
1, 2, and 3. The last one I saw was the summer. Red Gamer says, once Stranger Things final season comes out, I'm sure people would ask me to review.
Yeah, fuck off. Why is he touching his face so much, dude? This dude is tweaking the fuck out. Look at him.
You know, I didn't see-
we're scratching the beard. We're picking the ears. We're scratching the goatee. Touch the nose. Touch the face. Scrub the skin. What is wrong with this dude? Can we, please... One of those edit channels, there are a lot of great ones. Please make a face-touching supercut of just like half an hour of him just purely touching his face. You could probably pick all that footage up for like 2 pre-streams. That is, shit is crazy.
I play catch up a bit.
It's insane.
I've never been to an NBA game, no. I was never really into basketball.
Yeah, you shouldn't go there. There's too many people you don't like. Okay, racially speaking.
Watched the last season. It was actually way better than the mall season. Hobo X says, interesting note about the whale. Brendan Fraser was sexually assaulted by a Hollywood executive when he was younger, correct?
Correct? No, now. Now. They did it yesterday.
He was laughing
during the Oscars.
Until this. That's what I heard, right? Yeah. Like, he had a good career going. But then some executive thought, oh, I'll just have my way with this guy. He's just a hunk of meat. You know, I'll treat him like that. And if he says anything, we'll, you know, we'll just kick him out. And that's exactly what happened. Like, this guy assaulted him. And he spoke up and said, no, this is insane that this
happened. Yeah, this is what happened to Corey Feldman as well.
Want to speak up and get this guy in trouble? No one cared.
Corey Feldman got, like, really fucked up stuff. But then he released an amazing record. Have you guys heard of, fuck, I forgot. Literally... Angelic to the Core? Oh, yeah. Angelic to the Core.
The guy, I guess the guy got away with it, and he got kicked out of the movie business.
It's so good.
For like 20 years. No one wanted to hire him. So, oh, he's trouble. What trouble? The fucking guy molested him. How the fuck is he trouble? Like, that. Think of how fucked up our movie business is.
Yes, it is, dude. It's, you know, really fucked up.
Today, but man,
for women, it's very bad as well.
That fucking business. For a while, I'm
it's
sure,
really
right?
bad.
And, you know, him, it's not only him. I'm sure there's tons of people who have unspoken stories. Women, I'm sure, probably even more, right?
Yeah, I'm sure Panda Lee has an unspoken story.
Bloomkit says, so happy Brendan's back. Seems like a nice dude who was treated like dirt. Came back stronger than ever.
This dude, like, sometimes they just focus on looking at his face, and it's so weird. It's such a weird fucking face, man. The way he barely opens his mouth to talk, it's like a really drunk dude.
Like I said, I never had problems with fuck. That. I thought for his roles.
Hey, big ups, Lubos, for the super chat, dude.
He was tasked to
He's
do,
a fed.
Never problematic. You never heard about Brendan Fraser was an asshole causing problems anywhere. You know what I'm saying? Jex Gaming says, you should tell us what you hope to improve and what you would want to see in season 2 of The Last of Us.
Snow Carl is a fed working day SP's case. The guy is deep undercover.
What is he hoping to get, though? What is Snowcarl hoping to get out of this? He's going to compile all the segments about him in, like, a dossier, and he's going to send it to Joe Biden, and Biden's going to look at it and say, yeah, throw this guy in Guantanamo fucking Bay. Throw him beyond Guantanamo Bay.
Listen, tonight, you'll hear a lot in my review. That's all I'm going to say. Here's the thing.
He's hyping up his future videos.
To say, hey, here's what's coming out in the review tonight. But what's the point of doing the review then, right? So I'm saying,
bro, you can be a mega DSP and just make, like, start recording now, do the review during the podcast, and then stop recording, upload that video to the second channel. There you go. We are the most DSP we could possibly be.
He loves Discovery Plus. There's a bunch of ghost shows, monster shows, and other
stuff.
Of
course. They're all real, Jade. All those ghost shows on Discovery are real. Especially Mountain Monsters. I love that show. I showed it to my girlfriend. She'd never seen anything like that before. And I told her it was real, and she was fascinated. We also watched Ancient Aliens, which is in, like, I don't know, season 16 or something. Man, they have nothing left to talk about. They're still talking about Roswell.
So yeah, again, every one of these channels has their own Plus service. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, Phil Plus.
How do you really sort through and see what you
DSP
like?
Reacts, DSP Gaming. WPIG Plus. That being said, Plus.
Airheads. Oh, God. I saw Airheads a bunch. Again,
That's all your fans. You can see them in chat constantly.
It was on HBO. I saw it a million times. It's a terrible movie, by the way.
Come on, dude.
Stupidest plot you ever heard.
Stop being so toxic.
A radio station with a fake gun. They don't even have a real gun. And they basically take over a radio station.
Okay. Stupid. You don't need to have a real gun. Nobody knows if the gun is real until you shoot somebody. That's a life tip. Nobody knows if the gun is real. They can't tell. The moment you point it at somebody, if it looks like a gun, they think it's a gun. Big ups Deep Fried Z for the subscription. To Meerkat Plus. And nothing I could do. Thanks for the subscription to Meerkat Plus. Enjoy your free trial. After that, you get billed $69.99 per stream.
Story says Squid Game.
Don't worry about it. It goes directly into your credit card.
Maybe
you don't even have to confirm any of it. I got it taken care of. Don't worry about it.
I mean, Squid Game's hype is pretty dumb. Was it like 2 years old now? So I don't know if people would really care about me reviewing Squid Game.
And Joker isn't. Joker is hype. Came out 4 years ago.
Fassbender Assassin's Creed movie. I have seen it once.
No.
A long time.
It's not worth.
I actually don't remember it that
much. It's not even worth shit talking. It's such a bland nothing movie. It's like nothing. It's like those Hitman movies they made. They made like four Hitman movies.
I think it's time for us to adjourn for today. Let's
adjourn, my friends.
And then we're going to jump into Hogwarts, all right? So, ladies and gentlemen, thanks for being a great audience. Thank you for relaxing here with me on the Level 1 Podcast. I hope that you enjoyed the show. And, of course, as always...
Nope.
I will actually
fucker.
Run a small ad break. It will not...
Yep.
I promise you...
Small
won't
ad break. I got ad block, so get cucked.
You know, nature calls,
fucking
nature calls.
Loser.
All right. Actually, we're going to go green for Hogwarts. Green break for restroom break.
Are you gonna beg? No, but he's back. Did he beg right before he started the game?
Alright. And then, sorry for the delay, final story mission, the endgame content. I received a $10 tip from...
Wait, these pig noises are on his side. What is making the pig noise?
I received a tip during the break, thank
you. Oh, we got a tip! We got pig noises, yeah!
Tip from...
$10. Big us, that's hot. It's a lot of money. We can get a subscription now, you guys. We can get Paramount Plus. Maybe if you tip some more, we can get Paramount Plus.
Alright, no problem. Yes, thank you very much for the anonymous tip. Basically, they sent me a message. Thank you to the anonymous.
Oh yeah, it's the boar on the wall.
Thank you very much. Okay. Anonymous tipper is the biggest tip of the day. So
yeah, that's awesome.
These are today here today.
Oh yeah, we get to show them off.
Just for this playthrough, and of course, in the rare occurrence that we hit a full tips funding of $150, the Slytherin scarf as well, the full ensemble. I'm assuming these are going to be the last 2 to 3 streams of the game. What's up, you Quidditch master? We're here.
Okay, we're playing video games now. This is getting super boring. So what should we do, you guys? What should we do? What should the thing that is going to happen is supposed to be? Right now, Boogie 2988 pity party hits all time low. Well, I'm not gonna watch this. This came out an hour ago. We're not gonna cuck Sir Dickstroke and Phil. We're not gonna cuck him. We're not gonna do that. That's an asshole thing to do. Let's do something else though. I don't know what. Playing the Cyrax Death Scream. I don't know why I would do that. Why would I even do that? That's a stupid thing to do. That's disrespectful. I didn't watch Sly's latest stream because I was working today. I didn't really listen to anything. But I might watch it tomorrow. I watched a little bit of the LTG interview. LTG is like the typical dude who pretends he's more intelligent by adding a bunch of like prestigious phrases. So he's not going to say, I disagree with you. He's going to say, I disagree with some of the tangential elements of the points that you made. And some stuff like that. It's completely like unnecessarily adding words to sound fancier than that. So that's basically what I heard. Let's see what else. I might just end this and go play some video games and then go to bed. Because it's earlier than usual because daylight spending, you know. And I love that daylight spending. And I mean, I guess, you know what, that's it. That's it. I'm just going to go and chill and have some fun and relax in the reality of the human existence to the best of my abilities because tomorrow I got work again. And we might just do another watch along tomorrow. Who fucking knows? But now I need to set up the forwarding to somebody who is going to get it. I think it's going to be Piece of Peace because he's going to go live longer than King Jad because King Jad is probably going to be done sometime soon. And... He's just gonna be gone, and then he's gonna leave you hanging, and you don't want to be hanging, you want to be banging. That's what you're here for. We're hanging and banging. And, yeah, let me set up the redirect. It's gonna be Sir Peace. And you are gonna go there now, because I'm not even gonna play some music, so you're gonna get teleported there immediately. Whoa, this is so cool!